You're telling the tailgate, you're telling all of Sun Prairie you're coming, and you just can't get out that basement, can you?
Well, there's a furry convention at the KI Center up here in Green Bay.
Sure.
I didn't want to miss it.
It's big.
Yeah, really huge. How are things at Buck and Honey's other than...
What happened? Tell us what's going on. How come there's no Wildy?
Well, so I was... when I planned on coming down, we were hoping that the bus would get there, and we have an event tonight at Buck and Honey's. And you know that Buck and Honey's holds a very special place in my heart, regardless of the fact that I didn't come there. Because not only is Tommy a good friend of ours...
Yeah, you haven't come to a Buck and Honey's, though. And you've
had Yes, I have. I actually ate at one more recently than probably any restaurant other than Rustique in Green Bay.
Okay.
I ate at the one in the Monona right off the Beltline. It was great, by the way.
Oh, good one.
Yeah. But it holds a very special place in my heart, not only because Tommy's been such a good friend of the show, but the very first... Wildy and Tausch remote when our show first began way back in 2016 was at Buck and Honey's. So it always has had a special place in my heart. But I had to come back right after the show today. So I heard you were buying lunch for the entire team out of your own pocket.
Yeah.
Which I think is great.
What lunch too.
You're so generous.
That's why I'm here.
I just don't. Yeah, I was surprised. I thought, you know, this could be fun. And you know what? In fairness, Jesse thought, like, that the tailgate tour was going to just hang out in Sun Prairie.
So did I.
I don't understand.
Do you guys understand what tailgate tours are? You don't sit in one spot. You're on a bus.
So I know they've got, like, the stops in Beloit and Wausau and kind of all the places that they've been this week. But what
Platteville.
Else do they – like, what do you do during the day? Because the event is later today at Angel Park here in Sun Prairie, benefiting Sunshine Play. It's awesome. Like, they're doing this later. So what are Bulaga and Mark Murphy and Mike Daniels and what are they doing right now? Or – in 2 hours, like, are they just
on a bus?
Are they in?
They go stop at a school, or they stop at a children's hospital, or they stop at local communities on the way. You try to hit a bunch of spots. I believe they're in Platteville last night.
They were.
I guess I don't know. Hopefully, trivia's Platteville to Sun Prairie, Wisconsin today.
Not geography.
My guess is you're gonna probably hit a couple spots on the way. You know, what do you think? They just come plop down and say, all right, we'll see you at 5 o'clock. Like, that's not how tailgates work.
Do you stay in a hotel or do you sleep on the bus all week? Like,
no, you stay in a hotel.
So they got to be in a hotel somewhere.
So, yeah, in Platteville would be my guess. That's where the event was last night. Then they get up, they have breakfast, then they go, and they go have another stop. They'll do another stop before they come here.
This isn't common knowledge for the rest of us.
How it is not common knowledge when you hear the word tailgate tour. Do you just assume someone goes and it's not called the Sun Prairie Pit Stop or the Platteville Pit Stop? It's a tailgate tour. And the fact that both of you guys didn't comprehend that kind of blows my mind.
All right. So if I may briefly defend my honor, I understand that the tailgate tour.
I don't think you did.
Requires.
Because I think you bailed because you thought, well, those guys aren't even going to be there. I'm not coming. And what do you mean they're not there? It's the tailgate tour. You thought they'd just be hanging out at this gas station across the street from Buck and Honey's waiting to come over. I'm dumbfounded by your guys' idiocy on this.
I will wear the idiocy comment just fine.
Jesse this week was – literally when I told him it was like I slapped him across the face. What do you mean they're not going to be there at 9 in the morning? It's in Sun Prairie all day, no?
So I was under the impression, as having not attended the tailgate tour or ridden the bus, I did follow it to one destination many years ago to its, like, first stop. But I thought, all right, so they were in Platteville last night. I figured the bus then makes the drive from Platteville to Sun Prairie overnight. They stay at one of the more luxurious hotels in the greater Sun Prairie area. And then they do a bunch of stops in Sun Prairie. Mm-hmm. They go to the high school or the middle school. They go to a daycare center. They go to an old folks home. Then they do their event tonight, and there might be some time within their schedule to hang out with us at Buck and Honey's and enjoy the great food and have a bunch of guests on the show. And when Jesse informed me that that was not in the offing. He said, you know, so if you don't want to come down, it's okay. And if Jesse, who I think is our boss, sort of.
I don't think he is. He's definitely not my boss. I can assure you of that. I can't speak for you, but I know for certain he's not mine. No offense.
So when he said that, when the boss sort of says that you don't have to come, I said, well, okay, then I guess I won't. So it is 5 hours in the car. I got a lot to do today. It is a long round trip. You don't come to visit me very often up here in Green Bay, and that's fine. I don't hold a grudge, but apparently you hold one. You were very much looking forward to seeing me.
I'm not even going to go down that road. That's fair. I mean, you guys, the comprehension level on y'all's understanding of tailgate tours is mesmerizing to me. Like, it's just dumbfounding.
So are some of our ardent fans, like Buck and Honey's doesn't do breakfast Thursday, right?
Brunch on the weekends.
But today's Friday, so there is no brunch
I'll tell you what's exciting, though, and this would have been something, because I know we've always been trying to find you a hobby, and you have none, and then you got into pressure washing. They got a great patio at the Monona one there, but they have a great patio at the Sun Prairie location, and they're pressure washing it. That means you know it's getting close to patio season here, too. They got it's all going to be all nice and cleaned out, and I don't want to speak for Tommy and the team at Buck and Honey's. I think the patio is going to be open this weekend. I'm going to put it on them. I think they're going to open the patio.
It's supposed to be like 70 degrees.
Yeah,
that would be
get
great.
It open, Tommy. Let's go. I think Buck and Honey's patio, it's the best. Come on out all weekend long. I think the patio will be open.
Well, we certainly love our partnership with them, and we love Tommy and everyone over there. I guess now would be the time where I ask, though, since you're still working to get the video stream operating down there at Buck and Honey's.
Yeah, we're working on it. Sorry.
I'm not criticizing. I'm just pointing it out. Mm. And the people that are watching the YouTube or Twitter, I'm not even retweeting it right now because it's just me. I would be curious. What do we expect to occur during the window of our show with the tailgate tour? And I ask the tailgate tour expert that is Mark Tauscher, since we're, I believe, idiots when it comes to the tailgate tour. Like, is Mark Murphy going to swing by at some point to hang out with you guys? Because then, I would say there's a better chance of that now that I didn't come down. Is Bulaga going to stop by? Like, do we have any idea if anything tailgate tour related will in fact occur during the 9 to noon window on which Wilde and Tausch is on the air?
No, there was never going to be. That's why I don't comprehend what. No. Now, is there, I believe, Jesse, as the content creator of this show,
mm-hmm.
I believe somebody's calling in, right, from
so
the bus?
So here's what I can share.
Oh, yes.
Oh, boy.
So during the 10 o'clock hour, they will be en route to wherever they're going. I'm sure Tausch knows everything
they're not just
they'll be on their way somewhere.
Oh, just wait. No, there's a bus. They parked out right in front of Buck and
Honey's. No, there's not.
From the east side of Sun Prairie to the west side of Sun Prairie.
They're camping. They actually just started a fire out there. They're going to start a little campfire.
We have been told, and we are in talks about someone on the bus will be calling in to join us while they're en route. So we'll we'll get a live glimpse into what's going on the bus.
Now, that'd be fun.
The latest update that I have is they're kind of all passing off like who's going to be on the phone with us. So Bulaga's on the bus. We don't want to talk to him because we talk to him all the time. Yeah. So Bulaga's nominating Rasheed Walker. Walker saying, no, it should be Kenny. And then Kenny saying, no, it should be Alex Green. So I don't know who's going to talk to us. It could be Mark Murphy by the time we get to 10 o'clock.
I feel fairly
confident. It's going to be the bus driver.
We don't know when they're calling. We don't know who's calling. Yeah. For all we know, someone could pretend to call it and be Mark Murphy, and we might have to believe him.
The rumor is it might be Shohei's interpreter. That is who may be our guest
I would love to talk to the bus driver if the bus driver did call in. Probably can't talk while he or she is driving, but
it's probably fair.
They could pull over.
Well, I guess we're locked into the bus driver now for sure, because when it gets back to the bus that you've said, I would actually like to talk to the bus driver, even Alex Green is like, sure, sounds great. We'll go get some late lunch, early lunch, late breakfast. All right. Well, we'll get ready for whomever decides to join us from the tailgate tour bus. I can tell you this, Rob Domofsky is not on the bus, but he is scheduled to appear coming up at the bottom of the hour. So before we get to him, we're going to talk a little bit about the aforementioned Rashid Walker, who he wrote about for today or yesterday, and I wrote about for tomorrow. What is his role actually going to look like, and how is he approaching the possibility that the Packers will pick an offensive lineman with their first-round pick? We'll talk about that, and we'll talk to Rob coming up after Tausch tells us about his love, not just for Buck and Honeys, but for Gene Adella and Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Indeed, you can turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella Windows and Doors. The luxurious look, the sleek design, and the custom colors available are guaranteed to give your home that extra pop to entertain and to keep you comfortable. It's the best of both worlds. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months. No, or you can have no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
There they are. If you're watching on the video stream,
we're on TV,
we have
Tausch.
Connectivity.
Oh, what a world, huh? What a world.
Tausch's attitude is great. You would think that he'd actually be happier that I didn't come down, which is a little perplexing. But nevertheless, Tausch is excited to be at Buck and Honey's with Jesse. We got Riley Yauch. That is not his penultimate show with us, hopefully. But he is working from the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. I'm here in Green Bay. The tailgate tour bus for the Packers rolls on. Rob Domofsky scheduled to appear later in the hour. We'll talk about Rashid Walker next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Panic strikes as you realize on Wednesday that Thursday is your anniversary. The reservations? Being secured.
We'll see you at 8.
The gift? Being purchased. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with early pay up to 2 days early on direct deposits. So even though they call you last-minute Lisa, we'll make your last-minute scrambling a bit easier. You've got this with early pay from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at EverlightSolar.com.
It's our lowest prices of the season at Blaine's Farm and Fleet. Right now, shop unbeatable deals on the things you need for spring. Like 3-pound bags of Estate grass seed, just $9.99. $10 off 36-pound bags of Estate crabgrass preventer, $26.99. Assorted 5-quart jugs of Valvoline full synthetic motor oil, $21.49 after sale and rebate. And Stabil gasoline stabilizer, just $9.99 a quart. Don't miss our lowest prices of the season in-store or online at farmandfleet.com.
Your first round pick is here. Unleash unbeatable deals at Metro Ford of Madison. Get into a 2024 Ford F-150 at 2.9% APR financing for 66 months. $16.41 per thousand borrowed. This deal available to qualified credit. Offers on the 2024 Ford Edge include 0% APR financing for 66 months. Before April hits the final round, score today at Metro Ford of Madison. Browse the inventory at MetroFordOfMadison.com.
From color-changing alexandrite to shimmering zircon and everything in between at Chalmers Jewelers, you'll find high-quality, affordable, one-of-a-kind pieces. We source straight from the gem cutters, and we manufacture in-house from start to finish. As the manufacturer, we believe in truth in pricing. Never pay more for quality and stunning, beautiful jewelry. She's one-of-a-kind, and so should her jewelry be. While others may send your jewelry dreams to someone else to make, with us, your dreams become reality with the help of our custom jewelers, with you involved the whole way. With a staff that has over 200 years of combined experience, why buy from a place that marks up jewelry made by the thousands? When you can buy direct from Chalmers for that one-of-a-kind piece that is better quality, often for less.
Chalmers Jewelers. In Middleton
and Madison.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Slow down on Monday.
Jesse and Tausch live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie, awaiting the arrival of the Packers tailgate tour bus, which may or may not just come straight to them and hang out all day at Buck and Honey's.
I think they're roasting marshmallows right now.
I don't really like your attitude about this.
I think a little campfire, it's beautiful. You're playing Pictionary on one of those big whiteboards. Having a great time.
Is Pictionary a campfire game?
If it's not, it should be.
I thought maybe ladder ball or
bags. You don't have a flat surface to write on.
I mean, if you have a big tailgate bus, you can put
putting out an easel, though. You just said he's got an easel.
Then where's your campfire if you're talking about this in a tailgate?
You got like a big white grease board. You put it under the bus.
Murphy can't be good at Pictionary.
I think he'd be better at Pictionary than he would be, like, Taboo.
Nice. Not bad, actually. Tausch will continue to give us imaginary updates on the Packers tailgate tour bus that is
so
not parked outside.
Wildy is covered. The tailgate tour has been going. I think I did, like, the second one. I think the tailgate tour has been going now 20-some-odd years. And the fact that Wildy had no concept of what was going on still is amazing to me.
You can continue with that narrative. I actually do understand it. I just thought they spent more time in Sun Prairie today, which was part of the reasoning behind you guys being at Buck and Honey's. So I'm glad that they are spreading cheer and green and gold happiness throughout the state, including in Sun Prairie. Jesse, you mentioned it, but let's give this one more pop before we move on. Tonight's event in Sun Prairie is what?
It's at Angel Park, and it benefits Sunshine Place. So this is going to be where the real action is, not us sitting around here with imaginary updates. Later tonight is the big show. So that's at Angel Park. You're going to be there, right, Tausch? You're going to be part of this thing. And it supports Sunshine Place, which supports services for families and individuals facing food insecurity, housing instability, and other barriers to family and household stability. It's a really great cause. You can learn more at sunshineplace.org to find out all the things that they do. But we'll give updates again throughout the course of the day. And, of course, tonight, everything benefiting Sunshine Place. And that's what's awesome about the tailgate tour, that all around the state benefits all these great different causes, and Sunshine Place and Sun Prairie, one of the many being supported by the Packers tailgate tour this year.
Tausch, do you have an actual like role in the event? Like, are you on stage? Are you gonna tell dad jokes?
Yeah, like, I got dad jokes in my pun book.
I'm bringing my.
All right.
Wow. That'll really pack them into Angel Park.
I'm not 100% sure how many puns I'm going to bring, but I will bring my pun book out to Angel Park tonight.
Can you pick your favorites and have Mark Murphy deliver them for everyone?
I don't know. I'm not sure where Mark's at.
Work together on that.
I think now that he's in front of, I think he'll be more buttoned up. But, yeah, I'll see if he's open to doing something like that.
Well, it's a big couple of days for you because you not only will be part of tonight's events in Sun Prairie, but also you got mentioned in Rob Domofsky's story about Rasheed Walker.
Oh, wow.
As an example of a seventh-round pick who can become a stalwart offensive lineman and starting tackle for a very, very, very long time. Rasheed Walker was the 249th overall pick in 2022. Unlike Tausch, he did not start as a rookie. He played four special team snaps his rookie year, but last year he started 17 of the Packers' 19 games, including playoffs, and it led to a reference about old T.
I don't think I realized he started that many games. I suppose David played one.
Yash started one. And that was it.
Interesting tidbit by Rob. That's a lot of starts.
That was my tidbit. But be that as it may, here's the part from Rob. The Packers have turned seventh-round picks like Walker into long-term starting linemen before. Mark Tauscher, a seventh-rounder in 2000, went on to start 132 games at right tackle over his 11-year career. Mm. Now, you did experience toward the end of your career, not early, I don't think. Maybe when they picked in the fourth round Alan Barber. But were you apprehensive every year around this time that they might take a tackle high in the draft and how that might affect your future?
No.
Because you can't live that way, or because you knew you were the dude?
No, I mean, you can always, for me, it just didn't matter because I knew every year stood on its own, and you had to go out and deliver. So, obviously, I didn't want them to take a tackle in the first round, in 2003, 4, 5, like that, mm-hmm. because you understand the economics and the business of football that they're going to want their first round pick or second round pick to play. But they also, from a coaching staff standpoint, want to win. And if you're doing your thing and you're doing what you're supposed to do and you're doing it consistently and the coaches trust you, nothing to worry about. So there's so many other things you can worry about. And what good is it going to do for me back then, Rasheed Walker, to sit there and pout and whine and cry and mope and sulk if they draft somebody at the 25th pick? Is that going to help him accomplish what he's looking for? Or is it going to put a spur in his boot, a craw in his daddy, I don't know, whatever other saying you want to say, say, you know what, let's let this thing go.
You should use that on stage tonight.
You focus and you let it rip and you try to figure out a way to continue to hold on to that job, because I don't care if they draft a kid number one, he is not going to be the starting left tackle going into training camp. Rasheed Walker is going to get that opportunity. And just like we heard Steno last year, Yash Nyman should have been able to secure that and run with it. He didn't. And part of that is credit to Rasheed Walker that he hung in and did what his deal was. So you're always in competition. Unless you're the highest paid, best player in the world, you're going to be in competition. And everybody knows they're drafting someone. They want to get younger and cheaper every year and better. And it's your job to not let them do it.
That was really good, except for the craw in your daddy.
Craw in your daddy?
So Rob and I and Wes Hodkowitz and a few others talked to Rasheed Walker before they departed on their tailgate tour. And we talked to him about this very topic. And we had Matt Bowen on yesterday, who said that Amarius Mims, the Georgia tackle, would be the kind of guy that you don't necessarily want him to start right away as a rookie. He started 8 games at Georgia. Packers had him in on a top 30 visit. So maybe there is this half measure where Rashid Walker's the starter for another year and Mims moves into the starting lineup down the road as a first-round pick. But you're right. It doesn't do you any good to mope.
So, Jason, here's the deal. This is the fascinating part, and this is why late-round picks constantly have a chip on their shoulder. Because if Rashid Walker was a second or third-round pick, we wouldn't even have this conversation.
You're right. You're right.
But you know totally. What? What was Zach Tom? What was he picked?
5th.
And nobody's having that conversation. I don't care. They could draft Orlando Pace Jr. and say he's going to be our right tackle. Zach Tom ain't giving that spot up. And there ain't anybody that doubts that. The fact that he's played at that level. So if Rashid Walker goes out and plays the first half of next season and is a stud, he'll be Zach Tom'd. And we'll be stop having that conversation.
Zach Tom, a 4th-round pick, I should correct. He was the 140th overall pick, so he went 109 picks
so
before Rashid Walker.
So this is why
did.
Draft picks matter, because the old saying and the adage about late picks have to constantly prove themselves, for early picks have to constantly prove that they can't, but you can do it, and you can prove it. And if Rashid Walker showcases that he is as good as he finished the season off, and he plays well, none of this other stuff matters.
But you would agree that Zach Tom has played at a higher level than Rashid Walker did 100%. And done it for longer.
Yes.
And that's why we're not talking about
him. I literally just said that, and that's why nobody is saying, well, they draft this kid from Georgia. He's played right tackle. Oh, okay, great. Zach Tom's going to play where he wants because Zach Tom's a stud. Nobody's saying that about Sheed yet because – he has not proven it over a long haul. And I think there's doubts. Oh, he's a 7th-round pick. Is he a fast enough feet? Oh, can he hold up, you know, against the best? You know, those are the questions he's going to keep getting. And when and if they draft a offensive tackle, the Georgia kid or whoever it would be, everybody is just going to assume, oh, he's going to take your spot. You know who's got control on it? Rashid Walker and say, no, he's not. He's not going to. Because he's proven he can block in his league. This young kid – he hadn't proven that yet. He's got all the skills and the talent, but that don't mean jack. I've seen plenty of first-round, second-round picks can't play a lick. Oh, they got great numbers. They move. Yeah, that's great. How are you going to handle when you get beat and it's loud? Are you going to say, are you going to bow up? I don't know. That's when you find out what you got. And Rashid Walker is able to bounce back and do that last year. I don't know if this new kid, that's the part that you can't test, that you see, you watch, and you understand it.
There's also the possibility that they feel good enough about him that they will not go tackle in the first round at all anyway. And
I'm telling you, in an ideal world, they want to get an interior lineman, a.k.a. I believe they want to have somebody that can be the starting center. I don't think they want to pay Josh Myers $12 million a year to be their starting center moving forward. I think they want to refurbish, get younger, and have another stud inside. That's what I think they want to do with that with one of those early picks.
The conversation we'll have with Rob Domofsky, who had some interesting statistics in his ESPN.com story, is Rashid Walker good enough that they don't have to draft a tackle? Because Matt LaFleur's answer initially at the NFL meetings was kind of wishy-washy. Then it was stronger, but he also pointed out that we'd seen great flashes, but not consistency from Rashid Walker. He also, as we all did, talked to Brian Bulaga about Rashid Walker, who, as we know on this show, watches film of every game very closely and had seen the improvement in Rashid Walker. We'll talk about that with Rob. He's scheduled to appear next. I also do wonder, and we can get to this with you later, but did you ever reach the point where you didn't feel like you had a worry? Like,
if you get to that point, you're in trouble.
Like, is that, because that's not necessarily complacency, right? Like, Jordan Love's not worried about Sean Clifford taking his job now. He's focused on being the best version of himself, but like, Does the chip ever go away? We'll talk about that as well. Rob, scheduled to appear coming up. Want to remind you that right now is the best time to refresh your space during Steinhoffel's three-day best brand sale. You can take an extra 10% off all of their best brands, Cannadel, Gasho, King Hickory, Flex Steel, and more, all 10% off. And if you need a little extra help transforming your space, save up to $200 on Steinhoffel's design services. Plus, you'll get a $100 Bucks gift card when you spend over $1,999. Today through Sunday only, you can shop both in-store and online at steinhoffels.com. Rob Domofsky scheduled to appear next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This weekend on ESPN Radio, Manny Machado and the San Diego Padres face Mookie Betts, Shohei Ohtani, and the LA Dodgers. Coverage begins Saturday at 8:30 Eastern and Sunday at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio. Presented by Progressive Insurance.
Join Prairie Athletic Club and spring forward your membership today. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher, encouraging you to save now until the end of August when you join the pack. The Platinum membership is everything you want and more, including Pilates, hot yoga, bar, unlimited training zone, and boot camp classes. Discover the ultimate wellness experience tailored just for you. Not a member? Not a problem. Guests are welcome daily. Head to prairieathletic.com or stop in today for all their membership specials. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
Time to plunge into the ice-cold take of the week. Brought to you by Patio Pleasures. Here's Mark Tauscher.
Davante Adams, still very bad. Davante Adams is not good. Davante Adams is historically bad.
So that's Josh DiMaggio's incredibly ice-cold take, and I think he also wanted Jeff Janis to replace him. And that just shows you again, that was 2016. Davante is now going to be a Hall of Fame player. So cold take, yeah, I believe that's a cold take.
Patio Pleasures, your place for cold plunges, hot tubs, and outdoor living needs. Visit patio-pleasures.com.
Stoughton Health, in collaboration with patient and family advisors, seeks to advance the healthcare experience at Stoughton Health by providing a forum for past patients and families to provide feedback on a variety of healthcare and other related topics. Advisors offer constructive feedback on their personal journey at Stoughton Health, helping to elevate the patient experience and increase satisfaction. Interested? Please call Amy at 608-873-2308.
Ben Brust here to tell you about Zimbrick European. They're Mercedes, Audi, Porsche, and certified pre-owned. But the best part is, I've been working with them since 2018, and the evolution has been a two-door, a four-door, and now it's time for an SUV. My life has changed, and it's changed with Zimbrick European. Being a dad has made it really important to have the comfort and the safety that the SUV will bring me. Again, Zimbrick European off the Beltline at Rimrock Road. Of course, I found the sexiest car on the lot. Check them out.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Experience virtual golf like never before at the Bogey Factory in Verona. From family-friendly mini-games to monthly tournaments, the Bogey Factory has it all. Enhance your swing with their state-of-the-art TrackMan technology, or play a full round on over 300 virtual courses. While you're there, enjoy their full kitchen and sports bar. Whether you're looking for a fun day out with family and friends, or a unique location for a corporate event, the Bogey Factory in Verona has you covered. For more information, visit thebogeyfactory.com. That's thebogeyfactory.com.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
This update is sponsored by UW Credit Union. For every stage of life, UW Credit Union is here for every you. Shop Pick and Save for your tailgate. Earn a free Brewers ticket for every $50 spent with your Fresh Perks card at Pick and Save now through April 16. Visit pickandsave.com/brewers for full details. Join UW Credit Union at uwcu.org. Insured by NCUA.
The 2024 NFL Draft on ESPN Radio.
Are you ready?
Live from the heart of downtown Detroit, Michigan.
The NFL Draft is now officially open.
The countdown rolls on. The 2024 NFL Draft on ESPN Radio, ESPN, and on ABC.
Rob Domofsky is not on the tailgate tour bus.
No. I think he's out there roasting a hot dog with Murph.
Oh, my God.
But I'm sure he had a better understanding of what today would look like.
I bet Rob's a Dijon guy. He likes a little Dijon mustard.
Bijan Robinson?
I like Dijon.
And Bijan. Well, we like Rob Domofsky, and we like the fact that he snuck your name into his story at ESPN.com.
I'd like him to promote the show when he does that. Article. I don't know if that's IPT or not, but that's what I would prefer.
How does it feel that you've gotten in his head enough where he went from thinking about you with the articles to just writing about you?
Flat out mentioning you, yeah.
You know, Rob's my, I think he might be my favorite now.
Well, bad news for Tom Silverstein. It is Rob Domofsky from ESPN.com. Rob, good morning. How are you?
I'm good, guys. How are you?
We're great. So the Rasheed Walker story to me is a very interesting one, and I thought you had some fascinating statistics that would indicate that maybe he's better than he got credit for last season. Tell us about those numbers that you included along with Tausch's name in your piece at ESPN.com.
Yeah, my bad for not mentioning the show. That was I don't know if that would have made it through the editors. What I should have said was I put it in there and the editors took it out. That's what I should have said.
But you're too honest. Yeah, you're honest to a fault.
Thank you for your efforts, Rob.
So Rasheed Walker, we all thought, you know, had an okay first year as a starter at left tackle, but there were, you know, some inconsistencies. But there's two things that I think, A, support that, but B, give you, you know, maybe pause to think that they don't have to draft a tackle in the first round or even the second round. He did allow 8 sacks, which was the most among any Packers lineman, and was probably – oh, there were probably maybe, I want to say, 15 or 20 guys in the league that allowed more than 8 sacks. However, according to ESPN's pass block win rate, which I believe is essentially they watch every play, and if you hold your block for more than 2.5 seconds and in that time the quarterback is unaffected by it, then you get a win. And he had literally the highest pass block win rate of any offensive lineman, regardless of position, tackle, guard, center, that played at least 450 snaps last season.
In the whole league?
That's number one in the whole league.
That's pretty good. Wow.
Now, his run blocking was about middle of the pack, I think was 37th out of 70 tackles.
Rob, Wilde, you guys remember what Josh Sitton said, right?
About wiping his rear end with
not the butt wiping.
I got higher grades from the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel because I was a source.
Oh wow, you're gonna throw that out there, huh?
He said many things, Tausch, as we have illustrated.
It basically was your pass block for dough.
Yeah, and that's, you know, he's probably one of the things he's probably not wrong about was that.
I can't believe we'll be throwing a shot at him like that. Wow.
Yeah, well, I do think, though, that like it makes you think, well, you know, maybe tackle isn't the absolute surefire, you know, pick at 25 or what's the next one, 50 something?
51? No, 41 and then 58.
So 41. Yeah, that's right, 41. You know, maybe it's not. Maybe they aren't taking a tackle. And maybe they do believe in Rasheed Walker. Now, Matt LaFleur's comment about, you know, he was our tackle this year when asked whether he's the tackle of the future. So, and then he quickly kind of changed course and praised him a little bit. But, of course, our friend Wes just heard the praise. That was an intentional.
but anyway, I appreciated it.
But, yeah, I mean, it is. I think, you know, here, if you're Rasheed Walker, and it's basically what I said in the lead of the story, you have literally no idea whether you're the left tackle for the next, you know, 6-7 years or you're out of a job if they draft somebody. And that's the crazy thing about this game.
Wow.
Is that, you know, you can think that, you know, you have a job, and then all of a sudden, based on the draft, you don't.
No, I mean, he's not going to be out of a job. He's going to be the swing tackle if he doesn't.
Well, right, yeah. Right, yeah.
So,
out of a starting job.
I think it's – I mean, there is no question they're going to try and upgrade that spot. I don't think anybody – you can just – you can read the tea leaves. That's going to be something. But it's going to be up to Rasheed to utilize some of that positive stuff. Yeah, he's got some negative things too, and see how he progresses. But, Rob, I really think that they want to find the center of the future. Do you think – if you had a guess right now at this time, is Josh Myers on this team after when we're looking at, what is it, April 13th today? Is he on this team next year?
No. In fact, I think the starting center is on this team right now, but it's not Josh Myers,
who
the long-term starting center.
Who's it going to be?
I was told by a couple people
this juicy?
That within the organization, they think Zach Tom – is a really good – is a Pro Bowl right tackle, an all-pro guard, and a potential Hall of Fame center.
Ooh.
So there's your set. There's your center.
Wow.
In my
opinion. Man, it is nice when beat guys bring takes like that. Holy
That's
cats.
A direct quote from
– That is take.
Bold
that's
and
him quoting
and
someone foul. In the building.
Wow.
Yeah, that's called reporting.
Wow!
Holy! That's not bold predicting.
Jason, did you hear that?
I did. In fact, I've heard that from Rob multiple times.
Yeah, Rob, you're my number one. Hey, Rob, you are my number one. Holy cats. So you're telling me somebody in that front office told you, because I was just saying, Zach Tom would have to worry. They draft a tackle. You don't have to worry. He's going to be, you know, if he wants to be the tackle, he's going to be the tackle.
Yeah, that's one of the benefits of going to the combine and being out late at night and running into people in the building.
What a bold and sexy take that was. Hall of Fame center is what you're telling me. Dwight Stevenson.
Wow.
Dermoni Dawson. Zach Tom.
Well, we'll see.
Wow. That just blew my mind.
Like, are you so blown away you have no more questions? Or
yeah, go ahead. I'm shocked.
While I'm just thinking of the next question, I will say that you talked about the Dijon mustard. Jason knows this. I am not a condiment guy. We've talked about this when you've been out on assignment, that I no ketchup, no mustard, no mayo for me.
So your fries are just straight-up fries, or you don't eat fries
either? I love cheese fries.
Cheese
I
fries.
Love cheese
but
fries.
You dip in nothing. You don't like an aioli? You don't like
I will eat an aioli or a chipotle mayo or flavored mayo, but straight up mayo on a sandwich, no thanks.
So ketchup for nothing, huh? You don't want ketchup on
ketchup,
anything?
Ketchup is the A number one, as Mike McCarthy would say, A number one bad thing. And in fact, I've said this before, there are many things, I'll just say it. I would rather eat a steaming pile of dog doo-doo than ketchup.
You would not.
Well, no, I know. I'm exaggerating, but...
That was a bold, sexy take right there, too.
At this point, Rob can say whatever else he wants, and he's
got a few gimmies.
He gave us exactly what I was looking for. Good. Yeah, he could say that he'd rather eat bird poop than ketchup, and we'd be like, okay, Rob, yeah, that sounds good.
Talking with Rob Dabowski from ESPN.com. Rob, did you know that do you know a lot about the tailgate tour? You've never been on it, right? Aaron Popke has never gotten you on the bus.
No, I'm not big on bus trips. What I know about
or ketchup.
The tailgate tour, what I know about the tailgate tour comes from standing outside the American Family Insurance gate at 8 a.m. before they leave and interviewing the participants most years. That's as far as I go with the tailgate tour. I've never been to one of the stops.
So that's exactly what we did earlier this week, and during that time, you got to reconnect with Alex Green, who was very excited to see you. I thought that
was
great.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't even remember ever interviewing him when he was sincere, but he was very – told me how good I looked and that I haven't aged at all. So.
What the hell is he another
maybe thought I was somebody else.
Another bold and sexy take. But the one thing I'm curious about before you go – is that when we go back to the offensive line, we had Elgton Jenkins there, we had Bulaga there, obviously Rashid Walker. It is in a weird spot, right? We just got done talking about what we think of the center position. And yet, in theory, depending on how the draft falls, the five that are theoretically starting could be very well opening the season in Brazil as the starting five. Like, it's not like it's this massive glaring need, even though they moved on from a five-time All-Pro and let two other guys who started a fair number of games move on. What do you make of where they're at on the line as a whole?
Well, clearly they were planning for that, Jason, with the rotation between Runyon and Sean Ryan, right? I mean, that was when you knew John Runyon wasn't coming back, so they were already sort of preparing for that. And while Sean Ryan didn't start, he played – and you could almost say, well, he's a returning player at that position. It's not—I mean, it is a new starter, but it's not a new starter, if that makes sense. And then, you know, if Rashid ends up holding the job down, you're right. But it's like the only position on offense, maybe other than one more tight end, but it would be more of a specialty blocking type of tight end. But those are really the only spots on offense where you're like, okay, there might be a little bit of a question mark. They, you know, they don't need – they're set at receiver. You know, running backs one and two appear to be set. Now, that doesn't mean they won't draft somebody in the third, fourth, fifth round, somewhere like that. But otherwise, you know, we've seen this before, but otherwise I think it's going to be a defensive draft, which, you know, shocking because they seem like they're all defensive drafts around here. But, yeah, it is look, the thing – the improvement for this team on offense is probably not going to come from new starters or new players other than Josh Jacobs, obviously. But it's going to come from how much the first and second year players from last year improved, you know, to this year. And that's where this team gets better, and that includes the quarterback as well.
All right, Rob, last thing before we let you go and we talk to Rashid Walker coming up. Are you going to Brazil? Are you excited to go to Brazil? And are you commuting to fly out of Chicago because of those darn runways that just aren't long enough up here in Green Bay?
I don't know for sure if I'm going, but if I'm going, I will be flying out of Green Bay because I will not be on the direct flight. There's last time I checked on Expedia, there was no direct. So I did look on the preferred airline website. It starts with D and ends with A and has a ELTA in the middle. Is the preferred airline of Rob Domofsky Travel and Leisure.
So you'll promote Delta Airlines, but you won't promote Wildy and Tosh. Okay. What else can we promote,
this has been
Rob?
Quite a roller coaster.
Rob, what's your drink of choice that you want to promote? Like, where's your favorite restaurant and everything else?
At this point, Tosh, Delta has given me more than the Wildy and Tosh show.
Whoa!
Dang! I find that.
I don't even have a Wildy and Tosh like coffee mug or T-shirt or anything.
Neither do we.
That's true.
It was $2,200 on the flight there, and I have sent my submit. My boss has asked me to send an estimated cost. And I sent them the estimated cost, and they're going to see whether they want to send one of us, meaning either me or our Eagles reporter, which is typically what they do on international games. They only send one of the two reporters. But this case, they said they were going to look into sending both of us. Apparently, you need a visa. Not only do you need a passport, but you need a visa to go over.
I thought I saw someone sent me something. You don't need a visa till after that game. It'll be the next year.
Okay.
But I don't know. Rob, if you had to choose.
If you listen
company,
to Tosh, you might not get
you,
to go.
Do you want to go?
I want to go because it's probably a place I would never go on my own. I wouldn't just say, yeah, let's go to Brazil. So from that standpoint, I would. The part that gives me pause is that it's the first game over there. And do they have the kinks ironed out? I mean, look, the London game was pretty cool to go to London. But from a logistics standpoint, getting places, getting to the stadium, getting to the practice, it was a nightmare. It took forever, and they've been doing it in London for how many years? And it was still, maybe that's London and the traffic, but I would rather go if it was the second time that they were in Brazil. The first one I think is going to be, you know, there's going to be a lot of things that they haven't thought of, and it might be a difficult trip. But no, you know what, if they're playing a game, I would rather cover it in person than not cover it in person.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Rob, we appreciate you, buddy. Thanks.
All right, have a great weekend. We'll be seeing you.
That is Rob Domofsky from ESPN.com.
He brought that smoke.
Yeah, well, apparently we need to get him a mug.
Yeah, I was just trying to think, like, is Delta paying him to come on their airlines? I doubt it. Maybe I'm wrong.
But at least we know how he would get to, say, Detroit if he wanted to go to the draft, because he is not going to get to go as part of AmFam's promotion.
No, calling all Packer fans, American Family Insurance wants to see you and a friend in Detroit for this year's draft. Enter the Dream Draft Day sweepstakes for the chance to win two tickets to the draft, travel and hotel accommodations to Detroit, customizable jersey, and much, much more. Go to AmFam.com/Packers to learn more and to enter.
More next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
The way they travel on the road and how they're built.
Because we're on Wisconsin Sports.
You think Doc thinks they're winning a championship?
Nobody covers the Bucks like 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here, and I'm ready to enjoy another feel-good Friday of Wilde and Tausch painted by Holm and Lindsay Paints. Stick around to hear a few of the best feel-good stories of the week coming up to close out today's show. And if you want to make sure you get your next paint project at home done right, well, then I suggest you do what my family did and trust the pro painters at Holm and Lindsay Paints. Get connected with the perfect pro painter for what your project calls for by simply stopping into any Madison area Holm and Lindsay location. The team at Holm and Lindsay will help pair you with the best pro for the job, and Holm and Lindsay is the one paint you can trust to withstand the challenges of Wisconsin's weather year-round. That's what makes it Wisconsin's best paint. Holm and Lindsay, great paint, great people. Check them out at holmandlindsay.com. And stick around for Feel Good Friday coming up to close out this edition of Wilde and Tausch, painted by Holm and Lindsay Paints.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by your Badgerland Chevy dealers, proud supporters of Badger Athletics. Go to badgerlandchevy.com. Spring practices are well underway for the Wisconsin football team. Head coach Luke Fickell met with the media earlier this week and talked about the importance of the spring practices.
I think this is a really important time for us. It's not as maybe, you know, hooting and hollering as it is of a true, true work day. But these guys got to come out here. We got to work. We got to compete.
The spring session for the football team consists of 15 practices and several open days, which involve meetings. Thursday marked the end of practice 6, with the 15th and final practice happening on May 2nd.
Get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months. Book before April 30th at PellaWI.com.
Join the Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock, for retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Get the information you need as you plan for retirement. That's retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Investment advisory services offer the retirement income strategies and SEC-registered investment advisor.
LabCorp Clinical Trials is changing to a new name, Fortrea. While the name may be different, Fortrea combines decades of great experience and professionalism with new opportunities for clinical trial participation. It's more than a mission and more than a new name. Fortrea is dedicated to moving healthcare forward. To learn more about the future of healthcare and upcoming clinical trials, visit us at FortreaClinicalTrials.com. That's FortreaClinicalTrials.com.
It's our lowest prices of the season at Blaine's Farm and Fleet. Right now, shop unbeatable deals on the things you need for spring. Like 20-pound bags of BioAdvance 24-hour grub killer granules, $27.99 after sale and $10 mail-in rebate. Get our lowest price of the season on Fast Orange Hand Cleaner with Pumice, $10.49 a gallon. And save $2 on CRC Pro Series Brake Parts Cleaner, just $6.99. Don't miss our lowest prices of the season in-store or online at farmandfleet.com.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Thanks to Rob Domofsky for telling us that he'd rather eat dog poop than ketchup, but also for telling us that Zach Tom could be a Pro Football Hall of Fame center in the estimation of some that work inside the building at Lambeau Field.
It's really tough to see somebody that plays the offensive tackle position as well as he does and move him into center. It's a big, bold move, man. That's one of those things. Now, if you draft that tackle, that's why if you're Rashid Walker, you just keep plugging, because maybe what might happen next year, you put Zach Tom in. You know, there's a lot of moving pieces with that whole deal.
Indeed, there is. Zach Tom will be playing in this league regardless. I think he's proven that. He will not be joining the Johnson & Sons paving team like you will be, at least albeit briefly, for one gig.
Indeed. And who wants a visit with old T? Well, if you are, Johnson & Sons is inviting me out to one of their job sites this summer, and that could be with your business. Book an appointment before May 31st, and you could see me out there with the crew. Got all the gear they've sent me. I got the level. I got a hard hat. I got a vest. I got a sweater. All out there, and I'll be ready to get out there and work. And you know, the winter here in Wisconsin, it is pothole country, potholes everywhere. I hope that's what old T's going to end up be doing. I'm going to come out there, and I'm going to get some of that good asphalt. We're going to get that nice leveled out so your roads are beautiful that you can drive on. That's what old T's going to get done. It'll be nice, easy work for the Tauschenator. Visit Johnson & Sons.
What?
That's what happens when you ad-lib a little too much. Visit JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com, and I'll start digging for my
heart. Why'd you end up in the UP?
Well, I'm trying to follow that tailgate tour. I think they might be up there.
Rashid Walker scheduled to join Jesse, myself, and the Tauschenator to kick off the 10 o'clock.
The Tauschenator, eh?
Oh, jeez, the Tauschenator.
Laying that asphalt, huh?
Yeah, it was something. Not sure where that came from.
We'll introduce.
It's not a woof, Riley.
We'll introduce Tausch to Rashid Walker. Next, it's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Hi, this is former Badger Pro Football Hall of Famer Joe Thomas. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN WTLX Monona, Madison. Good Karma Brands radio station.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kiev Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison. My name is Riley Yauk, and this is your Sports Center update brought to you by Goodman's Jewelers, the diamond store of Madison for generations. Check them out at 220 State Street and online at goodmansjewelers.com. Unfortunately, none of Wisconsin's professional teams were in action yesterday as the Bucks had a day off and the Brewers got rained out in Cincinnati. They rescheduled their date with the Reds for a day-night doubleheader all the way on August 30th.
Thankfully, both squads are back in action today. The Brewers have a particularly interesting matchup against the Orioles. It'll be a battle between baseball's top two prospects. Both are 20 years old. Both have a dynamic power-speed combo. And both are named Jackson. Churio versus Holiday, live in color. Thankfully, not on pay-per-view, but, I mean, Apple TV Plus isn't too far off. Good luck finding that. Regardless, Freddy Peralta's on the bump for the crew. Barring the rain, first pitch is scheduled for 6.05 p.m. Then the Bucks will be in OKC to take on the Thunder in their penultimate regular season game. Tip-off is scheduled for 7 p.m. with pregame coverage beginning at 6:30. Right here on Madison's home for Bucks basketball, 100.5 ESPN.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
The 10 o'clock hour of Wildy and Tausch begins now, and it begins not with more Mark Tauscher, who just called himself the Tauschinator, but a player who has drawn some comparisons to Tausch, at least in Rob Domofsky's story at ESPN.com. He is the Packers' starting left tackle. He is on the tailgate tour. He may be on the bus. Apparently, I don't understand how the tailgate tour works, so we'll have to ask him how it's working for him today. It is Rasheed Walker on Wildy and Tausch. Rasheed, how are you, man?
How you doing? I'm doing good. Yeah, we are on the bus.
Now, there has been some reports that Bulaga, who is a good friend of ours and who I covered for a long time, was going to do this appearance, and then it was going to be Kenny. And how did you end up with the short end of the phone stick and you got stuck with us?
I'm the youngest person on the bus. So everybody just, figured, she got this.
That's typically how that works, yeah.
But, on the bright side, I get to talk to y'all, so I'm not mad at it.
Oh, look at you. What a veteran play there, Rasheed. I know you're still a young player, but that was a veteran deal. So, Rasheed, how has the whole offseason been for you so far? You obviously finished the season strong. Give us a little taste into what your offseason's been like.
For this offseason, after the last game of the season, I hung out in Green Bay for about like a week and a half. And then I took a little vacation to Mexico. And then shortly after that, I got right back to work. We report to OTAs next week, so I had to make sure. My whole thing, I just wanted to make sure I was in shape and I didn't miss a beat when we got back to work. So, I've been working now, hanging out, and then I was honored to be invited to the tailgate tour. It's my first tour. My first time doing a tour, and I've been having a blast. We've met we've met thousands of fans, talked to a bunch of kids in a bunch of different schools.
We lose him?
Oh, yeah. Oh, no, there he is.
Losing signal on the bus.
Well, that bus is moving. Jason thought the bus was just sitting there. Sheed, who's the funniest person on the tailgate tour?
I have to say Mike Daniels. Mike Daniels has been keeping he's been keeping everybody entertained. I'm pretty sure y'all know about Mike. Yeah, he's been keeping everybody entertained for sure.
That answer did not surprise me at all. Sheed, going back to your workouts for the offseason, when Domofsky and I and Wes were talking to you earlier in the week before the bus tour left, you talked about how your workouts, you've tried to make them more game-like to get you ready for more playing time. What is that? We didn't get the follow-up because you guys had to get on the bus. What does that mean? How have you altered your workouts to try and be more game-like?
Everything I do, I've been working on my functional movements a lot. I've been doing like a lot of isolated weightlifting, because I use independent hands when I'm, doing my passes. So, I've been doing a bunch of like independent dumbbell work, resistance, a lot of footwork drills. I've been doing a lot of punching drills, like burn. Just doing things to keep that muscle memory. So, deep in the season, when I'm tired, I can just fall back on my training.
So, Rashid, we were teasing Rob Domofsky from ESPN earlier. He joined us before you did, because in his story about you at ESPN.com, he references Tausch, who played 11 years in the NFL, started 132 games, was a seventh-round pick like you from a Big Ten school from Wisconsin. And I'm just wondering, as we, because we all asked you about this before you guys left, but how are you handling the uncertainty of whether or not they might draft a tackle high, maybe they don't? How confident are you that no matter what happens, you've proven yourself in this league?
You know, with that, I just try to, you know, worry about things that I can't control. You know, I just stay confident in what I can do. Like, I know I'm a great player. You know, I know what I'm going to bring to the field. Every time I step on the field, I'm going to do my job. So, you know, as far as, like, the draft, like, I don't got nothing to do with me, really. I can't really control it, so I don't really think about it much. You know, regardless of what happens, I'm going to come in with my head down and work. You know, I'm going to try to contribute to the team. But I do feel like I'm the man for the job.
Rashid, when you look back at how last season played out, was there a moment, and I ask a lot of guys this question, when you knew you belonged? Because I think everybody, especially late picks, you know, we all work hard and we want, but then you have that moment, whether it was in practice or in a game, where you were like, yeah, I know I can do this.
I always knew it. There was never a doubt. I always knew that I could do it. So I would say, like, early in my career, I didn't realize how intense, like, being in an actual NFL football game was. You know, it's a little bit different than college and high school. Everything's a little bit more faster. You know, you can't take any false steps. You can't miss a beat when you want to blow the play, especially when I'm on the line. So, you know, once I got settled in, I think one of the plays where I came to the conclusion that, you know, I was what I was supposed to be when I think it was the Rams, and it was like a dancing thing. You know, ball, one of the linebackers thrown to the ground. I was like, yeah, that was easy. So that kind of, you know, gave me more confidence just to know, like, boom, if I just play fast and free, then I can do it. So,
talking with Rashid Walker on Wilde and Tausch. He is on the tailgate tour bus as it makes its way to Sun Prairie, where Tausch and Jesse are eagerly awaiting its arrival.
You think Balaga's making him get, like, coffee and stuff because Rashid's the young guy? He makes him
question.
Come on our show. Is Balaga forcing you to, like, go get him food, and like, or has he been a pretty good dude so far?
Yeah, everybody's been pretty cool. We've been so busy, like, I think we're making about 4 or 5 stops a day.
Yeah.
So, Rashid, a couple more things and then we'll let you go. First of all, do you know who Mark Tauscher is that you're talking to? Like, I know you know who I am because I bother you at your locker on a regular basis. But are you familiar with Tausch's resume?
No, I need to do my homework on that. What's up with the resume?
Well, he set a hell of a standard as a right tackle for 11 years with that team. All right, I wanted to get to one other thing with you, and that is you have exuded confidence when we talked to you earlier in the week and when we talked to you now, and I don't think people understand, because you're a seventh-round pick, and you and I talked about this during the season, you know, you were a 4-star recruit. You had Ohio State recruiting you. You chose Penn State. Like, you played a hell of a lot of games with Sean Clifford, with the Nittany Lions. Is confidence a crucial part of handling whatever the challenge will be this season, whether it's competition with a draft pick or just being the starting left tackle? Is that an important part of your game?
Yeah, I feel like you have to be confident. Once you do, you have to be confident that you have to play fast. And, you know, that all really comes with preparation. So, you know, that's something that I had to learn, like, throughout my journey last season. Like, it's all about how you prepare, because, you know, whoever's prepared the best has a better chance of, you know, winning. So, you know, that all kind of ties together, like, confidence, preparation. Like, if you're not prepared to do your job, you probably won't be that confident, you know what I mean? So everything kind of just ties together.
All right, Sheed, I look forward to seeing you at the off-season program. Don't let Bulaga give you a hard time, and we appreciate your time, buddy. Thanks. That is Rasheed Walker live from the Packers tailgate tour. I love the fact that Tausch, and again, I know that this is an important part of the game, and I'm sure you had guys that you played with or saw who didn't have that confidence level, and you saw what it did to them. But he authentically does not seem fazed by whatever it's going to be, whether he's going to be the starting left tackle or whether he's going to be competing with some high draft pick. He does have a lot of confidence.
He seems to have the right attitude, and again, he has proven that he can play. So now I think he realizes that they're going to probably bring somebody in. We'll see if he's up to the task to hold that, whoever that guy that comes in is going to be.
So from what you saw from him last season, and Brian and you and I talked about him multiple times late in the year, if he's the starting left tackle, are the Packers fine?
Yeah.
I agree.
Fine.
Yeah, I think so too.
But I thought they'd be fine if they played Yosh Nijman too last year.
Yeah, that's fair. All right, well, the tailgate tour rolls on. They are on the move, as we noticed as he went in and out on his call. Surprised that Mike Daniels is keeping everyone entertained?
Oh, no, Mike is an incredibly entertaining dude. I kind of assumed that was what that answer was going to look like.
You never overlapped with him as a player, though, right?
I did not.
I think he was drafted a year or two after you had departed, but he's certainly always been entertaining when he's joined us. So the tailgate tour, again, is making its way to Sun Prairie. It will be there later today at Angel Park. Jesse,
mm-hmm.
And
that
again,
is correct.
Tell us more about what the good works are that they're going to be doing while they're there.
Yeah, the tailgate tour stop in Sun Prairie today benefits Sunshine Place, which is an awesome organization right here in Sun Prairie, helping out a bunch of people. You can learn more at sunshineplace.org. It supports services for families and individuals facing food insecurity, housing instability, and other barriers to family and household stability. 1 in 14 adults and 1 in 9 children goes hungry in Wisconsin. So Sunshine Place strives to enhance the health of our neighbors in need with supplemental food and meals, among many other causes. Again, you can learn all kinds of details about how you can get involved. Sunshineplace.org is where you can find all the information and support the cause.
Jesse and Tausch are live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie. Want to remind you, before we move on with this fine program, that Fleet Farm's Fleet Rewards program gives you the chance to earn rewards on your purchases. I'm earning rewards left and right. I got another $5 in Fleet Bucks that I'm going to use later today. You can join today for free and start earning those same rewards towards your next $5 reward in Fleet Bucks. Visit fleetfarm.com/rewards to join Fleet Rewards and learn all about the program. And if you're already there, you can check your balance and find out more about all the great deals that come with being a rewards member. And if you're getting ready for spring fishing, Fleet Farm is here to help you get all the gear you need. Shop their huge selection of rods and reels, plus check exclusive lures you won't find anywhere else. Find it all under one roof at Fleet Farm, your fishing headquarters. More from Buck and Honey's. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Dog, I can't remember a game that was this good.
Yeah, you know what else would be great right now? Some food from the Great Dane.
I know, but we can't go right now.
Good news! The Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company is available on DoorDash and Uber Eats. Stay in the game with the full menu delivered from the Great Dane closest to you. Downtown, Hilldale, Fitchburg, or East Madison. Order today with DoorDash and Uber Eats or on thegreatdanepub.com. Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's original brew pub since 1994.
From color-changing alexandrite to shimmering zircon and everything in between at Chalmers Jewelers, you'll find high-quality, affordable, one-of-a-kind pieces. We source straight from the gem cutters, and we manufacture in-house from start to finish. As the manufacturer, we believe in truth in pricing. Never pay more for quality and stunning, beautiful jewelry. She's one-of-a-kind, and so should her jewelry be. While others may send your jewelry dreams to someone else to make, with us, your dreams become reality with the help of our custom jewelers, with you involved the whole way. With a staff that has over 200 years of combined experience, why buy from a place that marks up jewelry made by the thousands? When you can buy direct from Chalmers for that one-of-a-kind piece that is better quality, often for less.
Chalmers Jewelers. In Middleton
and Madison.
Now's the time to make those big spring purchases at Fleet Farm. Husqvarna mowers, Minn Kota trollers, Goodyear tires. Fleet Rewards credit card members can enjoy special financing for 3 full years on qualifying purchases. So don't wait. There's never been a better time to get everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. 36-month special financing available on in-store purchases of $1,499 or more after discounts made with your Fleet Rewards credit card. Now through May 1st, 2024. Subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See customer service for details.
Hey, soccer fans. Forward Madison FC is back for their sixth season at Breeze Stevens Field. The 2024 home opener kicks off on April 13th at 6 p.m. against league rivals Richmond Kickers. Don't miss a minute of the action. Flock to the stadium and cheer on the boys in blue as we go full Mingo. Visit ForwardMadisonFC.com to buy your tickets today. That's ForwardMadisonFC.com.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Thanks again to Rasheed Walker for joining us from the Packers tailgate tour bus. Boy, it really is all about seniority, and young guys really do get all the assignments that other people don't want, like talking to us, don't they?
Yeah, that's how the world works, especially in professional sports.
That's what I was just going
to
say.
I feel like it works that way in most businesses, too, probably to a much lesser degree. But sports, there's a hierarchy,
mm-hmm.
and you grow into hopefully getting to a spot, and it's not like it used to be. I'm not talking about hazing and all the other stuff.
Right.
I'm talking about you earn veteran status. There's some perks that come with being a vet.
So, Jesse, do you have veteran status at ESPN Madison?
I mean,
like, are you like telling Riley Yauch to do like the
let's ask it this way. Does Jesse handpick where and when he does play by play? I think the answer is yes.
Yes, I do. Yeah.
So he does have status. Yes.
He does like to go on, be the remote producer on site a lot when it comes with food and
perks. Restaurants and it'll, like, go sliding down Bernie's slide. I know we're still working on trying to get this year. Yeah, if there's something in it for me, I tend to put myself in the situation to succeed. So I would say yes, that's probably where we're at, I guess.
So I think it was important that you're at Buck and Honey's. I'm not complaining. I'm thankful that you're there. Mm-hmm. When did you let Riley know that he would be coming out of the bullpen and producing from the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios?
He's had a week's notice. I was looking forward to the three of us all being here together and hanging out.
Sorry to disappoint
you. Getting lunch after the show.
Great.
Yeah.
Having some hangout time that we don't usually have together.
You know what we have to start doing? We have to get Jason's haircut schedule and then plan our remotes around his haircuts.
Yeah.
That's what we need to do.
Or I don't need one for a while.
If we came to Green Bay, would he come out with us or would he stay in his basement?
Definitely, if you're going to get married, he's not going to come out. You know that.
I believe when we do the show from the Tundra Trio that we are together, and it is always a fun time, and I look forward to the next time that you guys are in town. I know you won't be here for the draft. I will be. The draft is less than 3 weeks away now. We're getting close.
Less than two weeks away,
yeah. I guess it was yesterday. Tausch, I one last thing on the offensive line before we move forward. If there is one position you are worried about on this team, what is it? Because I'm not, even with new starters or less than ideal experienced starters, I'm really not worried about the offensive line. I guess I could be worried about the depth of it. But if their starting five in Brazil is the starting five that it would be if they started the season at A, I think I'm pretty much okay with that group. Even Josh Myers, who came on last season and played a lot better than he did early in the year at center.
Yeah, it's just that can you keep everybody healthy for that entire time? And if you can, great. If you can't, that's when you start worrying because you lost a lot of your depth throughout with Runyon, you know, Yash being gone. So that would be the question that I would have. So you can never have enough good offensive linemen. I think we all know that. And then it just comes down to do you feel good about the people starting? Sure, you feel good about it, but you can never have enough guys at that position, and that's why I think every year you need to make sure you keep replenishing what you're doing.
Is there anything on the roster other than special teams, which we talked a little bit about yesterday, that you would say legitimately concerns you?
Yeah, I mean, I think you have to wonder about the inside linebackers. Do you have enough depth or who's there? And I know, I think Quay is the only guy under contract after next year, so that's a position especially – as you move forward with this new defense, how are you going to – you're going to have enough impact guys. That's a position I would think that they're going to look pretty heavy at early in this draft process.
Well, I know they like Isaiah McDuffie, who is going into the final year of his contract, but I don't feel like that's a position – if Quay Walker is who they think he will be in their new system – I don't think that that's a position they're worried about either. They certainly need to add depth there as well, but they brought back Eric Wilson. They brought back Christian Welch, and I think they feel okay about their depth there. But you're right. They will certainly have opportunities to add in the draft in the coming days. Jesse, you found something interesting, and I did too after you sent it along. The Packers are in such an interesting place right now financially. There's this piece at ESPN.com about the highest paid players at all the different positions. And there was a period where Jair was the highest paid corner. Elton Jenkins was the highest paid guard briefly. David Bakhtiari was the highest paid left tackle. And now, basically all we're waiting for is for Jordan Love to be the highest paid quarterback potentially and set the market because everyone else... So many young guys, they don't have a lot of expensive players anymore. I just thought this story was a really interesting glimpse into where they're at salary-wise. And, again, I just don't – it's interesting to me that there's so few Packers on the list. I think – is Jair the only one?
So when I was reading through it, unless I miss somebody, Jair Alexander is the only Packers player on the entire list, and it goes like three or four deep at every position around the NFL. So all 32 teams, every position, giving you the three or four highest paid players, and it even divides it by category with guaranteed money versus next 3 years. Jaire Alexander is the highest paid corner, and there's no other Packers player on the list at all.
Yeah, that is surprising. But you start looking at it, you had Bakhtiari, you had Rodgers, you had Devontae, and you completely flipped the entire roster. So Jaire's high paid. You know, Kenny Clark, depending on what you end up doing with him, with his contract the way it is, you have to pick and choose when you can't pay every position. And you found out quickly when Green Bay did do that, you start losing some things and you have an injury or two, you can really get set back. But that day is going to be coming. And you don't want to be in a position where you're not paying guys, because that doesn't mean you have that type of players. Now, McKinney is probably going to be one of the highest paid safeties, correct?
He's not in the top three either in total per year or total guaranteed money. So they paid him a huge contract, but Derwin James, Minka Fitzpatrick, Jesse Bates are all ahead of him. He does have an annual average of $16.7 million. That puts him third in terms of average per year.
Well, you know what? That's the plus of having first and second year players play as well as you did. Then it's, are you going to take advantage of it? You went and picked up Jacobs. You went and picked up McKinney. You still have more to play with. I wouldn't be shocked if, you know, the draft doesn't fall right. Maybe there's a veteran that's not one of those high-priced guys. You go out, snap up for a year to kind of let that roll.
We'll get to some of your texts from the Talk and Text line, 844-770-3776, coming up next. Tausch and Jesse are live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie as the Packers tailgate tour rolls on. Want to remind you, the official bank of the Packers is, of course, Associated Bank. And if you're looking to make the switch, there's no better time to do it than right now. Not only do you get the best customer service in the industry, but you also can sign up for Packers checking. AssociatedBank.com/Packers to find out more. You get 10% off the Packers Pro Shop in-store and online. You get a nifty Packers debit MasterCard. And I think we've got some events that might be right around the corner, so keep an eye out for that as well. AssociatedBank.com/Packers to find out more. More Wilde and Tausch live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie. Stick around.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
The Packers Tailgate Tour is coming to Sun Prairie on Friday, April 12th to help support Sunshine Place, a nonprofit community resources center dedicated to household stability in Sun Prairie and Eastern Dane County. Sunshine Place provides meals, clothing, and living supplies, along with a wide array of social and community services to community members facing food insecurity and other hardships. Join the Packers Tailgate Tour in supporting Sunshine Place of Sun Prairie and Dane County. Visit sunshineplace.org to learn more.
Step into nostalgia with the Miller High Life Dive Bar of the Week. Listen to Rutledge and Hamilton every Thursday, and we will let you know where you can enjoy $2 Miller High Lifes. To celebrate our love for dive bars, me and Matt are going to tell you about some of our favorites, featuring one extra special dive bar that will have $2 High Lifes on special for the week. Taste the champagne of beer in its natural environment. A delightfully different dive bar in Wisconsin, like Caribou Tavern, Snack Bar and Grill, The Pub at Pleasant Springs, and The Dam Bar and Grill.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Ben Brust here to tell you about Zimbrick European. They're Mercedes, Audi, Porsche, and certified pre-owned. But the best part is, I've been working with them since 2018, and the evolution has been a two-door, a four-door, and now it's time for an SUV. My life has changed, and it's changed with Zimbrick European. Being a dad has made it really important to have the comfort and the safety that the SUV will bring me. Again, Zimbrick European off the Beltline at Rimrock Road. Of course, I found the sexiest car on the lot. Check them out.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Get the beat of the Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Your weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks and conversations with the biggest names in basketball. This week, Marcus and his son Chris are joined by ESPN NBA writer Tim Bontemps. Find Hear District now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, or wherever you get your podcast. The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame, Dollar, Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokunbo sits down with special guests on Thanalysis Show. Presented by Potawatomi Casino Hotel.
Thanasty.
Find Thanalysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching Thanalysis Show.
Watch every ESPN Madison show live every day. Subscribe to ESPN Madison on YouTube for live video of every show and exclusive content. Just search ESPN Madison.
Continuing live, well, me from my basement, but Jesse and Tausch live from Buck and Honey's. Did I hear a rumor that Tommy is there and he's going to join us coming up later in the show?
I can confirm that rumor better than I can confirm what was going to happen from the tailgate tour bus. I can confirm that Tommy Anderson's going to hop on with us in a few minutes, yeah.
Jesse, you had some texts that you wanted to get to before Tommy joins us and fills that empty seat. What's gotten your attention on the text line?
So since we're talking so much offensive line, Ian in East Troy has sent in a text. And there's always a Badgers player that I think we as Packers fans kind of fall in love with as we get closer to draft time. So Ian in East Troy asks, would you reach for Tanner Bordellini and draft him in, like, the fourth round because of his versatility on the interior, whether it's guard or center?
Anytime you have to ask a question, would you reach? The answer should be no. Not when you're in this position. If you're, you know, sitting there and you don't have anyone and it's a spot that you're desperate for, you're in a bad spot. But I think Tanner Bordellini, when he joined us, we saw what he did at the combine. He put on good tape. I don't think he's going to be around late fourth. And I don't think you're going to reach. You're going to get a really good football player if
right.
Tanner Bordellini becomes the guy that you're thinking about. So, no, you should never be thinking that way. And especially, I think Green Bay is in such a good position that even if it is safety or one of these spots that we really feel like they need to add another piece, I think Goody is disciplined enough to just say, listen, man, this is the way our board looks. This is a really good football player. We're taking this player at this spot at this time.
But if you're it's not Prize Picks necessarily, but if you're predicting, you think it's more likely they make a trade and target someone and move up and give up some draft picks than stay put and pick every round, right? Aren't you?
I don't
that group?
Think early. I'm looking more at that, you know, third, fourth round where you can sit and keep accumulating and you want to bring talent in. But that's the case where, oh, that center dropped. Oh, that or this safety that we kind of had valued a little bit higher than maybe other people did. They've fallen. They're not going to get to us at 70 or whatever pick that's going to be. Let's move up. We'll give up a fourth to move up to 15 spots. And then this is that's more along the lines. I don't think I'm actually going to be interested if Green Bay, with all of the quarterbacks that are going to go, is there going to be somebody that really values and maybe Green Bay trades out of 25? The thing with Goody is we've seen him be very aggressive as far as taking picks with Jair. Right? He traded out of, I think it was the 16th spot, right, and moved back up after I think New Orleans gave him that first-round pick for the next year. Then they moved back up because, all right, well, we have this extra capital. We got the first round for next year, and we really like Jair Alexander, so we're going to trade with Seattle and move back into the early 20s to get a player we really like. So the thing with the draft, it's so unknown. You don't have a clue until you start seeing how the board goes. But from a Packer fan standpoint, you want to see a ton of quarterbacks go before that 25th pick because that means there's a lot of really good position players that are falling further than they should.
Jesse, what else has gotten your attention on the text line?
Don in Mayville asks a question that, Jason, I think you have a chance here to match Domovsky's heat, the fire that he was bringing when he joined us. So
someone in the building told me.
This is your chance. Don in Mayville, are there any Packer trade rumors?
Someone in the building told me that there's been conversations about that 16th pick with the Seattle Seahawks, which we've all talked about ad nauseum. So, no, nothing.
Why don't you call Schneider and ask him?
I usually text with him more than call him.
Just text him right now and just say, hey, we're on the show. Any truth to the rumor that you're thinking about dumping 16 to the Packers?
Let's so if you're John Schneider, because the point that you just made is an excellent one. If those quarterbacks are all coming off the board, even ones that truly don't deserve to go in the top 10, but because of the position they play will do so, and you push down further good players that play positions other than quarterback, that 16th pick gets increasingly more valuable, right? Especially if there are GMs that believe that there's a drop-off somewhere around 20 to there's a lot of guys that are about the same between 20 and 55 or whatever it might be. If you're John Schneider, I don't care if you're buddies with Goody or not. First of all, you're in the same conference, so you're competing in the same NFC. But aren't you auctioning off that pick to the highest bidder? Packers aren't necessarily going to get it. And aren't you waiting until draft day to make that type of a trade because you want to extract the best deal you can from whomever is willing to pay it?
Are tomorrow's prices the same as today's?
No.
It could go the other way, too. It's just like buying stocks, buying Bitcoin. Yeah, it's great. Everybody now can sit and say, man, I should have bought 7,000 Bitcoin when it was at $17,000. Well, yeah, no blank. But you don't know. These quarterbacks.
Is that a good price?
There's a lot of, you know, it's at 70-something now, so you can do the math on that. You can look at this and say, well, everybody's telling me J.J. McCarthy's going to be here and the Vikings are going to do this. Yeah, that's what everybody says, but that doesn't mean that's what's going to happen. So while you could sit there and say, well, yeah, I'm going to hold off and wait. Yeah, maybe that'll work. Or maybe you're going to get your best value right now because there's the uncertainty. So it's easy to sit and speculate and to do all that. But at some point, and this is where I think Minnesota is going to be aggressive because they keep talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to go, I think they know they need to bring somebody in, and I think they like somebody. And I don't necessarily know it's J.J. McCarthy because good organizations, and obviously Minnesota has been up and down with that, you don't let people actually know what you're doing.
Right.
So that's why I think there's so much smoke. and so much. They need to move the draft up. I'm getting a little drafted out if I'm shooting straight with you. There's just too much. Well, it's like, let's go. What are we doing?
It's been the same for years.
No, it hasn't. They moved it back a couple years ago, and it's dumb. Like, it should be. It's always been this time of the year, right around the Masters is when it happens. And you're actually hurting the young players by not letting them get in earlier. What are we doing, dragging it all the way to the end of April, early May? Move it back, but I understand you want to own calendars and you want to do it, but I would say the draft needs to move up at least one more week and preferably two, because the draft industrial complex has plenty of time to get its stuff done, and I think you're actually not helping the young players because you're not letting these guys find out where they're at until May. Season starts in September. Give them another month. Like, what are we doing?
I think you're right, though. You understand the fact that the NFL wants to own the calendar, and they want to do it this way. And
they're going
to
own the calendar.
But to Tausch's point, and this is why you just don't roll your eyes at old T. Do you know when Mark Tauscher was drafted in 2000, when the draft was that year? First of all, it was only 2 days. It was Saturday.
I don't have any problem at all with them going. If they want to go 4 days, they should go 4 days. Drag it out. Matter of fact, I thought the first round of the draft should be just the first, and you just do 10 picks each. Thursday 10, Friday 10, and then give it another week for the second round, and then just let it rip.
So you want to move it up.
Move it up and drag it out.
It when it's going on.
If you want to suck the calendar like they do, move it up. Have a Monday night draft. Start the draft week. Have it draft week. Start Monday, top 10 picks. Tuesday, next 10. Wednesday, and then go Thursday. We don't need to do 2 weeks. Thursdays, so round two, round three. And then Friday, boom, boom, you finish, it's over.
The 2000 NFL draft, to Tausch's point, was April 15th and 16th. So
and
it
let me
started
tell you
10 days
we
earlier
We all wanted
than
the
this
draft
year's.
To be the end of March.
But yeah. it's been over a decade since they've been doing this Thursday, Friday, Saturday end of April.
It has, but it was still while, yeah. It was like the 20th, 21st, 22nd the first few years, and then obviously now there have been years where it went the last day was like May 1st or May 2nd, and that is Tausch is right that goes too long. I'm not super excited about the fact that you're all drafted out and we still have 10
well,
days,
I'm not the
11
only person
days.
That's drafted out. I mean, I think, listen, we'll continue to talk and we'll continue to evaluate, but this is the time of the year where it's all misinformation. It's misinformation most of the time. Now it's just who can spin the best story to try and get it. So my point is, let's just get this thing rolling.
Yeah, I saw something earlier in the week where three different Giants beat writers had three different reports about three different quarterbacks that the Giants might be interested in, because clearly their GM is trying to get as much smoke out there as possible and try and drum up interest for their pick because of the quarterback question that some teams have, and they obviously have Daniel Jones. All right, well, there's no smoke when it comes to Coors Light. There are only Blue Mountains and Tausch's love for his favorite
Coors Light, brewed with a three-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and it's cold packaged, so it's made to chill, born in the Rocky Mountains of Colorado in 1978. Coors Light's refreshing, it's crisp, only 102 calories. That's why it's Coors Light in my hand when I need a moment to chill. Sub, responsibly, Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
Our friend Tommy Anderson from Buck and Honey's joins us live next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
We're on the Bucks playoff push.
I am skeptical about the Milwaukee Bucks, and the Giannis thing only adds another layer of difficulty for Doc Rivers and company.
Hear every Bucks playoff moment on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
You, Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Big trailers and big opportunity at Stoughton Trailers. Learn more about why a career at Stoughton Trailers might be for you. Go to stojobs.com. Spring practices are well underway for the Wisconsin football team. Head coach Luke Fickell met with the media earlier this week and talked about the importance of the spring practices.
I think this is a really important time for us. It's not as maybe, you know, hooting and hollering as it is of a true work day. But these guys got to come out here. We got to work. We got to compete.
The spring session for the football team consists of 15 practices and several open days, which involve meetings. Thursday marked the end of practice 6, with the 15th and final practice happening on May 2nd.
Get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months. Book before April 30th at PellaWI.com.
When you're in the right place at the right time, things get done. The important things, like knowing what you need and how it all works. Talking truck. Fixing it right the first time. At Zimbrick Chevrolet, our people get it done right and now. That's how you know you're in the right place at the right time. And you'll never overpay at Zimbrick Chevrolet.
Free Food Friday on ESPN Madison is brought to you by Vintage Brewing Company. Whether you're looking to get carryout, delivery, or dine in, Vintage Brewing has lots of great options on their menu. Vintage Brewing Company prides themselves on being a great place to hang out and enjoy classic Midwestern hospitality. Vintage Brewing Company has multiple award-winning beers, so be sure to try one the next time you're in. Head to VintageBrewingCompany.com to make a reservation today. That's VintageBrewingCompany.com.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit GRBacademy.com to sign up now. That's GRBacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
As you're putting your spring calendar together, we'd love to have you join us Saturday, May 18th for Mark Osiki's 6th Annual Casting for Kids Fishing Tournament to support the American Family Children's Hospital, UW-Carbone Cancer Center. We're on the Madison Chain of Lakes early, then back at the Alliant Energy Center for 2:30 happy hour, dinner, and live and silent auctions with cool autographed hockey items, guided tours, and a brand new fishing boat. There's even more on our website, castingforkids.org. Help us help the kids. castingforkids.org.
We're on the Bucks.
This Bucks team looks too old to be able to make it to the finals.
Because we're on Wisconsin Sports.
They have the talent, but will they have the legs?
Nobody covers the Bucks like 100.5 ESPN. But I won't cry for yesterday. There's an ordinary world. Somehow I have to find. And this
Tausch and Jesse are live from Buck and Honey's. Not the Monona location, not the Wanakee location, not the Mount Horeb location, the Sun Prairie location.
Tommy, you know you've been hearing the warden from the Shawshank Redemption film many times on this show. I tried to do my best imitation so everyone could hear your various locations. How are things with you, and how excited are you to have those two knuckleheads there and not me?
Well, good. I was really bummed out when I walked in and found out Wildy wasn't here.
Well, he didn't have a haircut. He didn't have a haircut scheduled. You, you know, you can't get him out of the basement. It's tough.
Well, we miss you, Jason. Looking good though, thank you. Love the show. Listen to it every day. You guys are wonderful, and yeah, you're doing some fun stuff. So we're really happy you guys are here. Thanks.
Tom, you got any fun jokes? You always tell great stories when you come on. I don't know if I'm going to ask for any stories.
Put them on the spot.
You always got a couple of good jokes.
Right away with the good jokes. You know, there's a good restaurant joke, and we'll keep it clean, that I just heard that wasn't too bad. What did Sushi A, you like sushi, Tom.
Love sushi.
You do.
It's favorite food.
Yep. I know. What did Sushi A say to Sushi B?
I don't know.
What's up, B?
That's a not disappoint.
Yeah, all right.
That's pretty good.
You're welcome.
Tommy, what is your favorite food? So Jesse yesterday goes through this whole thing, and he's, I didn't know what your favorite food is. Like, who asks?
My wife, Becca, told me yesterday. She goes, what's Wildy and Tausch's favorite food? And I said, I've worked with them for 6 years. I don't know. I didn't know the answer. And she's how do you not know? I know everybody's favorite food.
Do you know how many of your employees, that's their favorite food? Like, is that a question you ask people?
No, I don't know. It's a topic starter.
Sure.
I guess it's a conversation starter. But, no, if you talked about favorite food, if you asked my wife what her favorite restaurant is.
It's Buckin' Honey's.
No, she'd say our kitchen at home because she just likes to be home. You know that. Though. So, no, but our
favorite that, by the way.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. I married an introvert, so, you know, it was a very functioning introvert. But, the thin crust pizza here at Buckin' Honey's is my dad's recipe. In 1977, he built Bomberino's in Lake Delton in the Dells. And I grew up making these pizzas. And then, our best sandwich, I think, is the TA's Hot Combi.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's an Italian sandwich with creamy Italian, and it's delicious. So a lot of good options at Buckin' Honey's. We make all of our own dressing, stock, soups, you name it. So you can't lose, man.
There's no doubt. Let's take Buckin' Honey's out of the equation.
Yes.
Tommy Anderson just goes to get a meal. What are you getting?
No, I'm a sushi guy. I love
wasabi.
Wasabi. that's kind of like one of those, like, once a month you go out and get sushi.
Yeah.
You can't eat it all the time.
Okay.
But yeah. You know, we've dined many good spots together.
Absolutely. Matter of fact, you were talking about Buckin' Honey's pizza. Legit, I just said we were over in Italy for a nice stretch. And when we were there, Max and I both were like, we like Buckin' Honey's pizza better than the pizza in Rome.
Yeah.
It's different there. It's simple, and I think it's just like an everyday food, whereas American pizza is better than Italian pizza.
Yeah, I've heard that before, and so thank you for saying that. Give Max a fist bump for me.
You got it.
Yeah.
All right, so Tommy, can you tell us a little bit about what your association is with this whole event and what's going on?
Yeah, the Packer Tailgate Tour is really neat. We applied. I'm on the board with Sunshine Place to back up. So Sunshine Place is a one-stop shop for people in need in Sun Prairie. We built it about over 20 years now. But we house our Sun Prairie Emergency Food Pantry, a bunch of social services in there, and really doing a lot of good things for people in need in Sun Prairie. And it's really a neat concept because it's all under one roof for people to come see. And we've grown it substantially over the years. But we always need funding to keep this going. The need for food security and just all the social services that we offer, it never ends. And the population growth is pretty strong here in Sun Prairie, as you know. So we're really proud of being able to help those people. But our executive director, Ann Maastricht, she applied for this, you know, just seeing if we can get lucky and get these funds from the Packers. And also it brings a really neat vibe to the community. Mm-hmm. So we're going to host a VIP party here from like 4:30 to 5:30 this afternoon. And then there's a large, I think, ticketed event that I'm pretty sure sold out at Angel Park. And there's going to be a live auction where we help raise a bunch of money. But Mark Murphy's going to be here. I think he's bringing like two or three current Packers and some veterans. I know Mark will be there, which will be great. And a bunch of ESPN contingencies. I think Jim Rutledge is even maybe doing a show from there tonight.
Yeah.
So we really appreciate the support from ESPN with this whole Packer Tailgate Tour. It should be a lot of fun. You know, and we love having the Packers here. And you know, just coming to Sun Prairie is a pretty cool thing for us, for the community.
Tommy, how I've told you this before, but I love the story behind Buckin' Honey's and who they were and all those aspects to your business side. But how did you get involved with Sunshine Place? Because when Jesse was talking about it earlier, like, it basically covers all the bases of the challenges that disadvantaged folks face, and whether it's food insecurity or housing or whatever it is, you guys are on top of all those things.
Yeah, I think that's a good question how it started. I was in a, it's called Sun Prairie Leadership back in, like, again, 20 years ago, with a group of people, and we toured the emergency food pantry that was downtown Sun Prairie. And this thing had, like, holes in the ceiling, I mean, refrigeration that was broken down, and it was just, I mean, it was not even a safe place to be, much less functional for long term. So we did a big raise. There's a couple families in town that did large capital contributions that are very generous to help kick this off. And we raised about $1 million back then, which was a ton of money, to build Sunshine Place. All privately done. We didn't go to the city, the government. You know, we really wanted to be, you know, bipartisan. It was really contributions from the community to build it. And what that really did was just come together and allow other organizations to go under one roof, Jason, so that it's been really neat to be a part of it and see it grow with a lot of people. We've got a really strong board of, you know, over 15 people on the board and stuff. So, yeah, it's a neat story. And Buck and Honey Birkebein, they once farmed and owned all the land in our original location here in Sun Prairie. They were big stewards of the community, too, so we kind of like to follow that spirit with this, too. So, definitely.
All right, I have two questions about the VIP event that I'm not attending.
I got an extra ticket, Jason. You move your haircut or take the girls to gymnastics tomorrow. I don't know.
My first question is, because obviously Tausch and I and Jesse, because of what we do, we talk to Brian Bulaga every week, or Mike Daniels is on the show. You're a Packers fan. I've seen you up at our pregame shows at the Tundra Trio before. If you have an opportunity during your VIP session, is there someone you want to talk to from the contingent that's there? Like, Mike Daniels, I think, is going to trump the wasabi joke with his entertainment level. Is he your first-round pick?
No, Mark Murphy is by far. That'll be fun. I'll ask him that question for the 16th seed if that rumor is true.
He might share.
He very well might, actually.
Yeah. I'll just give him a couple martinis and maybe that'll work.
And then the only other thing I'm wondering as a Buck and Honey's fan is, this is a chance to make me feel even worse about not coming down. Will the firecracker shrimp be on the menu tonight? The bacon wrapped dates, which I've had. I love the salmon there and the scallops. What are people going to be eating at the VIP event that I'm missing out on?
You're making me hungry talking about it. Yeah, we've got a great spread of all those things you just mentioned and a few other surprises that our chefs are working on. You know, I just met with our chefs yesterday. We have our new menu rolling out in the first week of May for the summer. We rotate our menus regularly, and the patios are rocking. We've got them pressure washed all week. And
going to be open this weekend.
Patio season. Ring the bell. That means patio season starting. And so we're excited for that. And a lot of fun things happening at Buck and Honey's with live music and great food and just a good vibe and experience for our guests to come out and see us. So thank you.
And I can get filet for lunch, which is what I try to do whenever I'm on Tausch's dime.
Yeah. Well, we wish you were here, Jason, and we're sending all the best. And I'm excited for the Masters this weekend, too.
Oh,
I think hopefully you guys have
Let's
a lot of talk.
Let's get that on.
Yeah.
Let's flip that up.
Yeah, we got it right here.
It's right in front of you on every TV.
But we'll get it over here for you, Tausch.
Okay, thanks, buddy. Yeah. It's nice that somebody's here looking out for me. Yeah.
You found the one TV it's not on. It's on like five other ones.
Yeah, it's
fair enough.
It's a good. It's going to be a good.
That's
weekend.
The best. Is that not the best viewing? Like, if you're just going to watch on TV, sit back. Isn't it the best?
Yeah, I planned something many years ago for this weekend.
I do remember that.
Yeah. Well, hey, you guys have a great weekend, and thanks again to ESPN. You got such great partners to Buck and Honey's and Sunshine Place, and just all you guys do. We appreciate you coming out and spending some time with us. It's awesome.
Tommy, we appreciate you, man. Thanks.
All right. Thanks,
Thank
Jason.
You.
Take care.
Tausch, you mentioned the Masters. Can you do Prize Picks with the Masters?
Yeah, Prize Picks has it all. It's the number one fantasy sports app. 3 million active members. All you do is pick more or less on 2 to 6 player stat projections, and you can watch the winnings roll in. And this weekend, you have some combat fighting. You got some golf, you got basketball, you got baseball, and my guy.
Your guy. Legend.
Justin Gaethje.
Nope.
Gaethje.
Nope.
Gaethje.
Nope.
Gaethje.
Nope.
Right, how do you say it?
Gaethje.
God, how do I get it wrong?
Gaethje.
Justin Gaethje. 0.5 strikes. Not a free square, but, man, that is a good one to jump on. You got that. Prize Picks has it all. Download the app. Use the code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
Riley's producing. He's like Mr. UFC. Do you need his insight on this at all?
Oh, somebody could have jumped in and helped. Yeah, somebody could have jumped in and helped. But
I was trying to. I tried to say it's Justin Gaethje.
Gaethje.
Yep.
Gaethje.
Yep.
Gaethje.
You got it.
You listen. We've been telling him all week. Now you're going to listen to him the last time you're saying it?
Good news is the fight's Saturday, so that'll be the last time you hear it from him.
Tausch and Jesse and anyone else who randomly walks by the camera live from Buck and Honey's. The 11 o'clock hour kicks off in 2 minutes, so stick around.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years, Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. And this month only, pay zero interest for 12 months and get a free shower door with your Lugstone shower remodel. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. That's KohlerServicesWI.com.
This is former Wisconsin linebacker Chris Orr. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN, WTLX, Monona, Madison, a Good Karma Brands radio station on Wisconsin.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kiev Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison. My name is Riley Yauch, and this is your Sports Center update brought to you by A Banner Year, celebrating the 10-year anniversary of the first of the back-to-back Final Four appearances for Wisconsin men's basketball. All four episode podcasts are now available. Subscribe to the Varsity Podcast on Apple, Spotify, and Wisconsin On Demand. Unfortunately, none of Wisconsin's professional teams were in action yesterday as the Bucks had a day off and the Brewers got rained out in Cincinnati and rescheduled their date with the Reds for a day-night doubleheader all the way on August 30th. Thankfully, both squads are back in action today. The Brewers have a particularly interesting matchup against the Orioles as it'll be a battle between baseball's top two prospects. Both are just 20 years old, both have a dynamic power-speed combo, and both are named Jackson. Churio versus Holiday, live and in color. Thankfully, not on pay-per-view. That's only UFC 300. But Apple TV Plus isn't too far off. Good luck finding that. Regardless, Freddy Peralta is on the bump for the crew. Barring the rain, first pitch scheduled for 6:05. Then the Bucks taking on OKC. Pre-game coverage starts 100.5 ESPN 6:30.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Thanks to Tommy Anderson and the crew at Buckin' Honey's. Not Monona, not Mount Horeb, not Wanakee, Sun Prairie. Where Jesse and Tausch are doing the show live with the Packers tailgate tour making its way to Sun Prairie. And it's a charitable event for Sunshine Place later in the day. Tausch, I know you get you entertain yourself with your Domofsky's your favorite beat writer, Silverstein.
Yeah, both really good. A lot of scoopage.
But one of the things that I don't think you would push back on, or maybe you would, is that when it comes to telling the stories of not just you, but every Packer I've covered, I am inclined toward the positive. You'd say that's fair, don't you?
Yeah, I think that's a fair assessment.
Mm-hmm. So I thought it was, and look, that doesn't mean that there aren't times where you have to write something that is not positive, as Mike McCarthy might say. But Riley's got this audio. I want to play it here. Jared Goff, who played in L.A., went to a Super Bowl with the Rams, was traded to Detroit,
Matthew Stafford goes to L.A. and wins a Super Bowl in his place. But Jared Goff, whatever you think of him as a player, has played well for them, and they have had success.
Yep.
Especially for a franchise that has not had a whole hell of a lot of success over the last, I don't know, five, six decades. And so he was doing a podcast, the Trading Cards Podcast. I don't know if he was talking about his, you know, his favorite Topps 1993 cards or what he was discussing, but he was also discussing the negativity of the media covering the Lions. Here is Jared Goff talking about that on the Trading Cards Podcast.
Yeah, so unfortunately, Twitter is not working right now. I'm getting a media could not be played on both computers we have here. I don't know what that issue is, but I guess I could play it off my phone and put
Dude,
it up
is
the
it
mic.
Weird? I thought Riley Yauch was Goff. Like, what the hell are you guys doing? It sounds like Goff.
They have the same voice.
All right, let's just do it this way. Okay, so
I can read what he said. It's in an article. I could read
there
it.
There is some, you know, some technical glitches,
it's
which
playing
happens
right here.
Riley,
I'm watching.
Read
him.
What Goff and do it in Goff's voice, and just say what he said.
Where is this article where
God.
It says?
Okay.
I just have the video.
This is like the time that Riley gets the opportunity on the show and then oversleeps and almost misses.
Riley, let's talk about you.
It's
and
not his fault. Right, Twitter's
Riley,
down.
Let's talk about you.
I can send you a picture
here
of what Twitter is showing me right now.
Let's
this video
about
is not playing.
Girlfriend. Riley, tell me more. How did it go when you went and met your girlfriend?
It went really well. She has a great family.
All right, so what? Give us a little play-by-play. So you just started dating and you went up to – give us the scoop. I think I missed the day you subbed. Let me hear the scoopage on that.
Yeah, okay, so I'll run it back for you. I think Jason's already heard this. I think it was –
not everybody listens every day.
Yeah,
so
yeah. True.
Yeah, but I do. Can I leave?
Yeah, go ahead.
Take a break.
I'm reading Jared Goff's article right now.
Yeah, okay. I'll just keep going then.
Do you want him to tell the story? Do you want the Goff stuff? What do you want to do right now?
I don't
know
what I want. Read the Goff stuff. Let's go.
Okay, thank goodness.
I have this, like, I probably need to drop it pretty soon here because I'm hopefully going to be in Detroit for a long time. But I have this thing with our local media where, like, they almost, like, relish in negativity at times.
I don't think you need to read all the likes.
Well, it's quoted in the story, so I feel like, and maybe that's what gets clicks and that's what sells, but it's no longer what they need to live in. Like, hey, guys, we have a good team. We've had success.
Like,
we can I'm just trying to get us through it, Jason. We can be happy about that. We can celebrate that and not have to write about how we're constantly the underdog. No, teams are going to be gunning for us now. We won the division and all that. I'm probably overthinking it in my head, and it's the chip on my shoulder and the competitor in me. Jared Goff said on the podcast, what was it called?
Yeah,
the Trading Cards.
Why I thought this was interesting when I sent it over is because, you know, when you look at how the Packers are covered, do you think they're covered in a negative way, Jason?
When things go bad, yes, but not as like the predisposition of the media. But this is kind of like the argument that I would get about I wasn't critical enough of Aaron Rodgers during his time playing. Aaron Rodgers won four MVPs.
Yeah, but he fell short in the playoffs every year.
Right, and when he didn't play well in the playoffs, we talked about it. But it's when you're the Lions and you have this culture of losing, there's a lot of negativity to go around because there's a lot to be negative about.
Yeah, but what I found interesting is there have not been a lot of negativity for 18 months.
Right.
Middle half of 2 years ago, and the fact that Goff goes on a podcast, and to say it, I think there's some self-loathing up there, and I think there's also the fallback. So I think Goff is looking at it and saying, what the heck is going on with this press, with this, you know, the beat that covers us? We have stunk forever. Now we're finally good, and you're still going to be this negative. And I believe he feels like it's because that's the business model y'all are in.
Yeah,
and I thought it was really interesting because New York, Philly, they have so much media. You're going to get a ton of negative. You're going to get – Green Bay, I would say, is mostly positive. If you're not a defensive coordinator, I think it's mostly positive. If you look at Detroit, you have a season like they had where they just fell short.
Yeah, they made the NFC title game.
It should have been rose petals and flowers everywhere. And when it's not, I think the players can look at it and say, what the hell are you guys even doing?
So, but let me ask you this from our perspective on this show, because when we talk about the Packers here as compared to the Lions, I don't know about you, but they went to the NFC Championship game, and yet I think we both believe that if you had to pick who's going to win the NFC North this year, we'd pick the Packers, and not because we're homers, because we think they're the ones that are trending in a much in a more positive direction. Not that the Lions are suddenly now going to bottom out after one NFC Championship game appearance, but I like the way the Packers are trending. I think the Lions are going to have some challenges. They're playing a first-place schedule, for example. Like, I don't know about you, but I don't think that that's being negative toward the Lions. I think that's just saying, look, it's hard to lord over a division the way the Packers did for long stretches in the NFC North. And the Packers, with their quarterback, seem like a team that could very well win the division instead of you. Wouldn't you agree?
What does Las Vegas say?
I can get that for you right after.
I don't believe that most people think that the Green Bay Packers should be favored over Detroit. I don't. Now, does that mean I don't think our fans and the people listening to this show or people that live in Wisconsin or people that are Packer fans? I totally understand why you would say what you just said. But Detroit has earned the right to have that. And they're not – it's not like they've regressed a bunch. Their O-line's still going to be really good. Their backs and, you know, their wideouts have gotten a year older too. Their quarterback is more seasoned than Jared Love. Jordan Love, Jared Goff. That's the part that I think is going to be – now, defensively, who would you rather have? The fact that their offensive coordinator stayed. I think the Packers should openly embrace. I don't think they're going to get it, but I think you should embrace that. Detroit's the king of the North, man. So we got to take it from them.
I have you have it, Jason?
Yeah, so help me understand this because you guys are better at this than me. The Vikings are the longest shots in the NFC North, according to four different sports books. I've got one that's got a composite of all of them.
ESPN Bet is our personal favorite in these parts, Jason.
I understand. But the bottom line is the Lions are plus 150 to win the NFC North. The Packers are plus 225. The Bears are plus 350.
Well, that's not – I thought it would be more. Yeah.
And the Vikings are plus 750.
Yeah.
So that means – that if you wagered $100 on the Lions winning the division, you would win $150 if they did it?
That's correct. Yes.
And the Packers, you would win $225. So the Lions are favored across. And, Jesse, the reason I did this is because, you know, look, some places view different conferences or different divisions differently, but this is unanimous. Mm-hmm. All four of these sports books, including ESPN Bet, have the Lions as the favorite. So it's if they're being negative in Detroit, that would be surprising to me. If it's negative here on Wilde and Tausch about them compared to the Packers, that's probably not as surprising.
I'm also seeing the Lions plus 550 to win the NFC. Only the 49ers have better odds than that. The Packers are plus 1,000 to win the NFC, so nearly double the odds for the Packers to actually reach the Super Bowl.
Yeah, and I think for people that are going to bet, I like the odds with Green Bay a heck of a lot more than I like with Detroit.
Mm-hmm.
So are we overvaluing the team that we watch most closely? Because I would argue throughout the years of this show, we more often than not focused on the flaws and why they might not be a favorite or why they might not be able to get
it done. That's Jared Goff's point. You're proving his point is that there is, and I think his deal – like, when you're the New England Patriots, that's how the world works. Like, it's championship or bust. The Green Bay Packers just had a unprecedented run of great regular season success, some playoff success, a couple of championships. But if you ask most Packer fans, they're disappointed you only got two.
Right.
And is that does that mean that Packer fans are negative? No. it means their expectations are higher. Detroit fans hadn't made a playoff, hadn't won a playoff game since JFK blown away. What else do I have to say?
Well, Aaron Rodgers said a lot about JFK apparently the other day.
Anyways, yeah. That when you start looking at it that way, I think Jared Goff's point is, why don't we love the fact that we're actually good? Instead of sitting here saying, well, the defensive backfield stinks, and the linebackers need to be faster, and all this other stuff. That's his point. And one thing you learn is you're never going to win going against the media. They always have the last say. So I don't know how that's going to be viewed by his folks or your colleagues in the media there. Is that typically goes the other way when you fight fire. That's why everybody's so nice to you guys, is because they hope that brings positive coverage.
All right. Well, I didn't think that the coverage of the Lions, but I read a few of those guys on a fairly regular basis, so I'm a little surprised that Jared Goff
feels this way. But we can agree that Jared Goff would read and see more than what we would.
I don't know. Maybe he shouldn't be, right?
Was he implying that, like, writers nationally, locally, whomever, saying that they're the underdog is a bad thing? Like, don't players want that mentality most of the time?
I really think it was more they focused on the negatives rather than the fact that we won two playoff games for the first time in forever. And, you know, the realization.
Because they were up big in the NFC Championship.
The realization is
lead.
Yeah. Nobody really cares, man. It's always about what you're going to do next. And that's something Detroit has never had to deal with. That's another thing. Handling success. And Dan Campbell knows it. You know, I loved how honest he was talking about he doesn't know if they'll ever even get back to the point where they're at. And that's why these things hurt so much, is because, and I got to go back because that analogy didn't get the love that I wanted last time, it's the Mount Everest deal. And I'm not going to go into the great detail.
Who are you, Jared Goff?
It's just
Goff?
The analogy.
Yeah.
When it comes to analogies,
what else
now?
You got,
you only
that
got the negativity.
That was great. We praised the Mount Everest analogy up and down, literally and figuratively.
Good one.
We also praise Quick Trip up and down. We always love our stops there when Sydney and Maddie and I stop there on our travels. So do Tausch and his family.
It's baseball season, so it's time for me and you to take a quick trip to the ballpark. For every $200 you spend at Quick Trip with Quick Rewards, you'll earn a free ticket to a Brewers game of your choice. That's right, big savings and free Brewers tickets. Visit the Quick Rewards app. Click on the Fan Zone button on the app, its home screen, to opt in, and you can start redeeming your tickets. You can redeem up to 6 Brewers tickets at a time.
Wow.
Who doesn't want to go to a Brewers game for free?
I do.
Using your Quick Rewards, you can go get all those samples, stuff your face, and you can get those Brewers points from Quick Rewards in addition to Quick Rewards.
I don't think that was in there.
Double the points. Double the happiness. Blackout dates and upgrade fees may apply. See quicktrip.com/ballpark to get it rolling.
Stuff your face with all the samples. Let's play some trivia.
One time.
Jesse, what do you got for today's category, and what caller would you like Riley to get?
In honor of the Green Bay Packers on the tailgate tour, what's the latest update from them, old T? Where are the Packers tailgate tour? Where are they right now?
How the hell do I know?
Because we...
What do you think? I have a tracker,
I think he was,
on my phone?
I think he was setting you up for they're roasting hot dogs in the
parking
lot.
They're outside, and the fire, and the hot dogs.
I kind of thought that bit got stale.
Murphy's telling stories. Never mind. Packers on the tailgate tour.
I didn't know where we were.
Is the category. Packers on the tailgate tour. Let's do caller 10 for Jordan Love.
Caller 10, 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776. Riley Yauch is standing by trying to get the audio of Jared Goff to play.
Give up!
Like, call now so Riley can, answer the phone and we can play trivia.
Why does Jared Goff say like that many times? He's a professional quarterback, done it like a million interviews. It drives me nuts when my kids say because I want to get it out of their lingo.
Yeah.
Jesse's reading the transcript. He said like
why would they put that in the transcript? Just take that out of the transcript.
Like, totally. Like, that's a sweet thing that the Lions like. Like, what? Come on, Jared. You're the franchise quarterback, man. You've been around 10 years. Or I don't know how many years he's been, but it's been 8 or 9 years. Clean it up, brother.
You should, like, be better than that. Caller 10 right now. 844-770-3776. Trivia's next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Mark Tauscher here for Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie, the name you can trust. While the new baseball season is in full swing, basketball's postseason is about to get underway, and Green Bay is ready to stock up in the draft. It's such an exciting time to think about all the exciting things happening in Wisconsin sports. And with all this excitement, maybe it's also time for you to start thinking about an exciting new vehicle. Well, if that's the case, start your search with Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie. Stop by the dealership on Main Street in Sun Prairie to check out their full inventory of new and used vehicles. Or make it even easier by starting your search online at ZimbrickChevrolet.com. And if you're not in the market for a new vehicle but want to make sure yours feels as new as the day you drove it off the lot, get a tune-up with Zimbrick Chevy's amazing service team. Stop into Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie and discover this great automotive team that I've been telling you about for years. Consistently recognized as a Best of Madison operation, Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie is truly the name you can trust.
The 2024 NFL Draft on ESPN Radio.
Are you ready?
Live from the heart of downtown Detroit, Michigan.
The NFL Draft is now officially open.
The countdown rolls on. The 2024 NFL Draft on ESPN Radio, ESPN, and on ABC.
Why are interscholastic sports called the last classroom of the day? Because they teach students important life lessons like teamwork, accountability, and perseverance.
Encourage your student to participate in the last classroom of the day. Interscholastic sports in Wisconsin.
It's ESPN Wisconsin's Brad Dortman. NBA fans, listen up. You've got to try Pick 6, the newest fantasy app from DraftKings, an official partner of the NBA. Getting started is simple. Select if a player will have more or less of a certain stat. For example, will a player have more than one rebound? Or will a player have less than 3.5 assists? Pick your favorite players and compete for huge cash prizes. Download the new DraftKings Pick 6 app now using code MADISON and take on the competition with your best NBA player picks. Only on DraftKings, Pick 6 with code MADISON. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. 18 plus in most eligible states. Age varies by jurisdiction. Eligibility restrictions apply. Pick 6 not available in all states. For up-to-date list of states, visit dkng.co/pick6states. Void where prohibited. See terms at pick6.draftkings.com/promos.
Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company is a Madison original, brewing award-winning craft beers for nearly 30 years. Whether you're a fan of Pilsners, IPAs, Stouts, or Sours, the Dane's team of brewers always have something new on tap. Or if you're in the mood for a classic, enjoy the German Pilsner or Crop Circle Wheat. For a full tap list, head to one of their locations in Fitchburg, Hilldale, Downtown, or East Madison, or visit GreatDanePub.com. Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's original brew pub since 1994.
Attention business owners and executives. Looking for a bank that's invested in your community as you are? Look no further than Starion Bank. As a Dane County community bank, Starion offers competitive deposit and loan rates while actively supporting local initiatives. Visit a business banker at one of our convenient branches in Middleton, Monona, and Sun Prairie. Starion Bank, full-service business banking, lending, and cash management.
Join Prairie Athletic Club and spring forward your membership today. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher, encouraging you to save now until the end of August when you join the pack. The Platinum membership is everything you want and more, including Pilates, hot yoga, bar, unlimited training zone, and boot camp classes. Discover the ultimate wellness experience tailored just for you. Not a member? Not a problem. Guests are welcome daily. Head to PrairieAthletic.com or stop in today for all their membership specials. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Dancing on the edge, about to take it too far. Messing with my head.
Live from Buck and Honey's, Jesse and Tausch are there. I am in my basement where I belong. And it's time now for trivia. Let's welcome in our contestant. Oh, it's not a Wednesday, so it's not up his alley per se, but mailman Matt. Matt, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. Safe and sound here in my Benzie Prius.
Nicely done. And nobody knows the state better. You know all your zip codes. Unfortunately for you, it's not Wednesday. It's not Wisconsin geography. Instead, it is the Packers on the Tailgate Tour trivia. And question number one.
I just realized I forgot the cheese fry helmet at the office. We're going to have to trust Riley to do the drawing today. I had this whole thing planned for you to pick it.
Did I not tell you yesterday that you were going to pick
it? Dang.
It's not easy to remember cheese fry helmets.
Time for question number one, which goes to Tausch.
All right, mailman. At which university was Mark Murphy, the athletic director, before becoming the president and CEO of the Packers? Is it Notre Dame? Northern Western?
North.
Go ahead. What'd you say?
Northwestern.
There you go.
That's rich.
Nice.
Yeah.
Really nailed that. Jesse putting a zinger in there with the third option.
And
which
he
never
just
got
so
to.
Happened to not get to it.
I didn't have
by
to.
Stalling and
nice
stumbling
job, mailman.
The first two answers.
It's because he said Notre Dame for the
that
first
was
one.
Which way
uh-huh.
No.
All
nicely
right, here
done.
We go. Mailman Matt, question number two is this. After playing most of his career for the Packers and one season with the Lions, for which NFL team did Mike Daniels play 13 games over his final 2 years of his NFL career? Mike Daniels finished up with the Baltimore Ravens, the Cincinnati Bengals, or the Cleveland Browns?
Tough question.
It is a tough question.
Yeah.
Stumped.
I mean, Matt thinks it's a tough question, yeah, too.
I do. I'm going to go with Cleveland.
Right
Wrong-o.
State. Right state.
Boy, Riley's really quick with that buzzer. He doesn't even build a suspense.
In fairness, it took a while for Matt to give an answer.
The Cincinnati Bengals were Mike Daniels' final NFL team. Tausch, you have question three for mailman Matt.
During his two seasons in 2011 and 12 in Green Bay, which jersey number did running back Alex Green wear? Is it 20, 28, or 31?
31.
Jesse, did you have his jersey or something? Because this is not an easy question either.
Well, the third question is not intended to be an easy question. It was number 20. I did not have an Alex Green jersey, although if I did, I guess I could have brought it to Sun Prairie today for him to maybe sign later.
When you think of the number 20 for the Green Bay Packers, who do you think of?
Kevin King.
I was going to say Atari Bigby was going to be my answer.
Kevin King getting blown away by Scotty Miller up the left sideline right before that halftime of that NFC Championship.
What else do you have to say?
Right there, number 20.
All right. Well, Matt, that didn't go particularly well, but you did get the first question right.
It was worse yesterday.
So you do have two of the possible four entries into what will now be apparently Monday's drawing.
Well, we could let Riley do it if you trust him.
Riley's not ready.
Does Riley have the requisite materials?
Well, he does, and he doesn't need to play any audio from Twitter in order to be able to draw the drawing. You can leave it up to him.
Riley, are you up to the task like you were the Jared Goff audio and a love letter to your girlfriend?
Yeah, I've done this before, so I think I'm game.
See?
You have the chips ready?
Not at the moment. I will rush outside during the break and see if I can figure
Give
it out.
Give him 4 minutes. He's got this.
And you need two chips for mailman Matt now.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, we will. The last time we went to you for some sort of responsibility,
The results were mixed. So we will give you the opportunity to totally redeem yourself. Hey, I need to redeem myself too, in fairness, right? Because I was going to talk about some of the cool things that Steinhoffels had going on yesterday. They were celebrating yesterday, National Pet Day, and of all the people to not talk about National Pet Day and Steinhoffels, for me to miss that yesterday?
That's pretty crazy.
That's a huge failure for me. So we all make mistakes, Riley, including me. But I can remind you that now is the best time to refresh your space during Steinhoffel's best brand sale. You can take an extra 10% off all of their best brands. Cannadel, Gacho, King Hickory, Flex Steel, and more. And they're all at 10% off. And if you need a little help transforming your space, you can save up to $200 on their design services as well. And I'm sorry that you missed National Pet Day at Steinhoffels. I know Danny, our friend over there, she's not going to be pleased with me. She loves our two dogs, Stella and Sadie. I could have gotten them to contribute, and I blew it. So I apologize to Danny and Chad and the whole crew. They are so great over there and such a great partner. But you can make your space great during the best brand sale. So make sure you shop in-store or online at steinhoffels.com. Whoa, Nelly from Jesse is next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
This is Wildy and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella Windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
All you have is one chance after an accident, one decision on who to call, one shot to get the help you need. Don't waste it on the one offer you get from your insurance company. Make the one call to Gruber Law Offices. It's the only one you'll need to make. Call us today. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown here from ESPN Madison. For the best Southwestern food and margaritas in the Madison area, it's always Pascual's Cantina for me. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pascual's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Plus, they have one of the largest tequila selections around. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at PasquaLsCantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pascual's Cantina.
Waiting to see a general surgeon? With Stoughton Health, it's always easy access, with most appointments within a week. And with over 160 insurances accepted, you're covered and in good hands. For more information, visit StoughtonHealth.com. Stoughton Health, creating excellence together.
Hey soccer fans, Ford Madison FC is back for their sixth season at Breeze Stevens Field. The 2024 home opener kicks off on April 13th at 6 p.m. against league rivals Richmond Kickers. Don't miss a minute of the action. Flock to the stadium and cheer on the boys in blue as we go full Mingo. Visit FordMadisonFC.com to buy your tickets today. That's FordMadisonFC.com.
The pulse of the Milwaukee Bucks.
straight from a Bucks legend.
Can't get it off. Marcus Johnson will, though. Can't leave him alone for a 12.
Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson on Bucks Plus. Marcus and his son Chris offer a weekly beat on Bucks basketball. Get your questions answered and hear from the biggest names in basketball. Find Hear District with Marcus Johnson at Bucks.com/plus on the Bucks app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
It's a beautiful day. Sky falls, you feel like it's a beautiful day. To let it get away on the road.
All right, Riley, before we get to Whoa, Nelly, do you have the cheese fry helmet? Are you ready to draw this week's trivia winner?
I am, in fact, ready to draw this week's winner. It
is... A lot of jangling.
Yep. It will be... Coyote Dan in Burlington!
I think it's just Yodi Dan. Yod. I don't think it's Coyote.
You're wrong, too. What is it,
Yote?
What did I say, Yote?
You said Yodi.
It should be Yodi.
Yodi Dan.
Nickname has to have two syllables. I don't think you can have a
Tausch
nickname. Yeah, I don't. That's not a nickname. It's just you're shorting my last name.
Tausche?
Some people call me that.
I'm calling for Whoa, Nelly.
If the topic is good, the guys discuss.
Just the other morning, I had breakfast at Tracy Rocker's house. His mama brought out 15 flapjacks. He said, "Mama, take back 5 of them flapjacks. I gotta stay hungry for the Crimson Tide."
But if it's not, the show must go on. It's time for
Whoa, Nelly
on Wildy and Tausch.
Alrighty, so Jesse has given me the reins for Whoa, Nelly today. Yeah, looking forward to it. Whoa, Nelly's a good time.
Riley.
What?
That's great. I'm looking forward to it as well.
Okay, awesome. Thank you. I'm glad. I'm glad. Anyways.
Talk UFC. Justin Gaethje looking?
Gaethje.
We're getting there. That's my second question.
Oh, God.
We're starting. I was actually inspired during the show. You guys were making fun of Jared Goff's accent and him saying "like" all the time, like
well,
that.
We never
California.
Got to actually hear it.
Yeah, that's true. But I can do my best impression. That surfer bro, like whatever, man. I'm just Jared Goff. I'm from California. So I'm wondering,
what?
That's what he sounds like, correct?
I never heard any audio.
Know.
So I don't know. I only heard Jesse.
I'm Jared Goff, dude.
Jesse's rendition.
He's from Cali.
I'm going to lead the Detroit Lions to Super Bowl.
I'm pretty sure that's exactly what he sounds like. He's from California. So, for you guys, what is the most annoying accent for you guys to listen to?
I think I just heard it. Whatever that just was, put it at the top of my list.
What do you mean, Tosh?
No, you know exactly what I mean. You guys just did it.
Jared
it's always good
Goff.
Something. Oh boy.
Should I go back and read what he said and do it in this voice?
Like, yeah,
dude. Why is everyone so down on Detroit, man? We're hosting the draft this year. We got a team that's got the second best odds to win the NFC, dude. Behind only San Francisco, man. Like, totally. We're
Jesse,
great.
Jesse, I think you've crossed the Rubicon of really irritating Tausch.
No, I'm not irritated. You know how sometimes you get like things in your head like, how the hell did I end up at this point in my life? That's where I'm at right now. What time is it? Yeah, that's where I'm at right now. I'm trying to piece this all together, and that was what was going on in my head.
Dare I say, Whoa, Riley.
Whoa, Nelly.
Okay, now it's time for the UFC talk. I know Jason hates when I do this. No, just let me finish, because this goes back to you, Jason, actually. So some context, UFC 300 this weekend, biggest UFC card probably of all time. Last weekend, Combat Sports Entertainment, you had WrestleMania, WWE's biggest, show of the year, whatever you want to call it. And I believe it was Wednesday on KBN, Jason made fun of producer Chris Larson's wrestling name, or again, whatever you call it. The UFC fighters also typically have those sort of nicknames. Justin Gaethje is the highlight. Justin the Highlight Gaethje is going to go up against Max Blessed Holloway. So I'm
Blessed?
Wondering.
Yep. His nickname is Blessed?
Blessed. Max
Two
Blessed Holloway.
Works.
Yeah.
Why haven't we just called Gaethje the Highlight all week? That would have been easier.
Wait, is Blessed two syllables?
Blessed? Blessed. I guess if you go Blessed.
Blessed.
Blessed. The best blessed. Is blessed.
I don't think that's okay. Anyway.
Anyway, so I'm wondering now, Jason, to put it back on you, what would be your either UFC, WWE nickname? Since apparently I forgot what Chris Larson's was. It was pretty bad. But what would be yours then?
Wouldn't that prove it wasn't good if you can't remember it?
Yeah,
probably.
Yeah.
I think the basement, based on the way that today's show has gone and me staying home. I would take the basement.
That's a good one.
Yeah, thanks.
That is pretty good.
Really okay,
good.
Jesse Tausch.
Go ahead, Jesse. I don't have one.
The Tauschinator.
We did get that earlier in the show.
That's pretty good.
Jesse?
I've never been in a fight. I don't know. I got nothing. The
10 pin.
You know what? If we want to go strike force. 10 pin.
Brooklyn.
Gutter.
Strike Force.
Yeah.
Where are you getting that from?
So, Tausch isn't actually going
to
contribute to any of these. He's just going to rip off.
I'm going Strike Force. I think that's pretty good.
That's actually a fantastic nickname for MMA, Jesse, as there used to be a promotion called Strike Force that eventually merged with the UFC. So, great work there, Jesse.
See?
Shows your knowledge.
Strike Nicely Force done. Versus the Tauschinator. UFC 301.
I'd watch that.
That'd be fun.
Want to see the Delegator against the Tauschinator. Whoa, Nelly.
Nelly.
Who's the Delegator?
Okay,
I'm being told that's Jesse's nickname. Apparently behind his back.
Mm-hmm. I thought it was
and
the
now
hall
to
monitor.
His face.
The Delegator.
Oh, you delegate a lot?
That's what I'm told I do.
Oh.
I delegate other people to find out if that is what actually happens.
Okay, getting back to some sports that people are more familiar with. The Brewers got rained out yesterday. And anytime the Brewers have a game that's rained out anywhere outside of AmFam, because obviously it can't happen there, Brewers fans go nuts and say everyone else should build a roof on their stadium. So do you guys believe that every other MLB stadium, save maybe like Yankee Stadium, Fenway, Wrigley, should build retractable roofs on their ballparks?
I mean, I think ideally you would want to have a retractable roof. And the fact that the Brewers did this in 01 and had the foresight to do it was genius. But it's real easy spending other people's money. Real easy. And I think building a retractable roof now is probably, I can't imagine the added expense, because there's teams, you know, the Bears are talking about building a domed stadium for their new field. And you think, well, why not put a retractable roof? Well, it's because it's going to be it's not cost effective. So I think it's nice to say, do that. But yeah, all right, if you're going to pitch in a couple $100 million, great. Otherwise, shut your mouth. That's, I think, how the attitude that these teams have.
Tausch, I'm glad you brought up the Bears. I was thinking about that same story. So it apparently has a $2 billion price tag. And it is going to be a dome, not a retractable one. And it's going to be, if it comes to fruition, roughly where Soldier Field is now. What do you make of the fact that they have basically, like Devin Hester on a kickoff return, reversed their field? They were moving out to Arlington Heights not that long ago. They had bought the land and everything else. What do you make of that change?
If you think that story is written, you're crazy.
I don't.
That's the whole part
your opinion.
Of you know, we discussed leverage. We discussed all this other stuff. Do I think that they want to be in downtown Chicago? I think they want to get a sweeter deal in Arlington.
And I think that's why they're doing this. They're, you know, playing
one against, the other.
Yeah. So how this ends up shaking out, I don't know. But you don't buy a ton of land and see how the Packers do it, New England does it, the Cowboys do it, and have all that real estate that you're able to make a bunch of money on. Do I think that the Bears ownership group or whoever ends up buying them, if the McCaskies sell, that that's the road that they want to go down? I would say yes, because is it going to make me more money? That's the question the owners have, and Arlington will make them a heck of a lot more money, especially if they get a sweetheart deal on the whatever tax breaks they need.
They paid $197 million for the Arlington International Racecourse. Apparently Churchill Downs owned it before, so yep. That's where that Arlington location stands. All right, that's it for Wool Riley.
Jim on the south side points out Tausch is a pirate is the most annoying voice he's ever heard.
Yeah, I could see that. I've never really ever done a good pirate, so I can totally see Jim OTSS point of view on that.
Tausch, you don't use an accent when you talk about Fortria, but it's an important conversation.
Not yet. If you're looking for tickets to Brazil, you want to go down to the game, you're looking for extra spending cash, Fortria's got you covered. Healthy men and women of non-childbearing potential, ages 18 to 60, BMI of 18.5 to 30. They have a study. One stay, 11 nights, couple follow-ups, $5,302 for your time. Another study, healthy males and females of non-childbearing potential as well, ages 18 to 65. This one, body mass index between 18 and 35. That study, one stay of 4 nights, 3 follow-ups, $4,430 for your time and participation. Go to fortriaclinicaltrials.com. That's Fortria, F-O-R-T-R-E-A, clinicaltrials.com.
We wrap up the week and wrap up Jesse and Tausch's visit to Buck and Honey's with Feel Good Friday, painted by Hallman Lindsay Paints. That's next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
The Milwaukee Bucks, the Oklahoma City Thunder.
Crowder fires away from three, and he rattles one through.
Tonight on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here, and I'm ready to enjoy another Feel Good Friday of Wildy and Tausch painted by Hallman Lindsay Paints. Stick around to hear a few of the best Feel Good stories of the week coming up to close out today's show. And if you want to make sure you get your next paint project at home done right, well, then I suggest you do what my family did and trust the pro painters at Hallman Lindsay Paints. Get connected with the perfect pro painter for what your project calls for by simply stopping into any Madison area Hallman Lindsay location. The team at Hallman Lindsay will help pair you with the best pro for the job, and Hallman Lindsay is the one paint you can trust to withstand the challenges of Wisconsin's weather year-round. That's what makes it Wisconsin's best paint. Hallman Lindsay, great paint, great people. Check them out at HallmanLindsay.com. And stick around for Feel Good Friday coming up to close out this edition of Wildy and Tausch, painted by Hallman Lindsay Paints.
You, rah-rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's home for craft beer and pub food since 1994. Find the Great Dane nearest you at greatdanepub.com. Spring practices are well underway for the Wisconsin football team. Head coach Luke Fickell met with the media earlier this week and talked about the importance of the spring practices.
I think this is a really important time for us. It's not as maybe, you know, hooting and hollering as it is of a true, true work day. But these guys got to come out here. We got to work. We got to compete.
The spring session for the football team consists of 15 practices and several open days, which involve meetings. Thursday marked the end of practice 6, with the 15th and final practice happening on May 2nd.
Get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months. Book before April 30th at PellaWI.com.
It's ESPN Wisconsin's Brad Dortman. NBA fans, listen up. You've got to try Pick 6, the newest fantasy app from DraftKings, an official partner of the NBA. Getting started is simple. Select if a player will have more or less of a certain stat. For example, will a player have more than one rebound? Or will a player have less than 3.5 assists? Pick your favorite players and compete for huge cash prizes. Download the new DraftKings Pick 6 app now using code MADISON and take on the competition with your best NBA player picks. Only on DraftKings, Pick 6 with code MADISON. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. 18 plus in most eligible states. Age varies by jurisdiction. Eligibility restrictions apply. Pick 6 not available in all states.
For up-to-date list of states, visit dkng.co/pick6states. Void where prohibited. See terms at pick6.draftkings.com/promos.
What is a better buying experience? Well, you're minutes away from a better buying experience at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. Jim Rutledge here. To me, a better buying experience is a personal experience. That's what Dan and his sales team have set up at Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb. You're going to have the experience that you're looking for. You're going to define what that better buying experience is for you, and they're going to get you in the vehicle that you need and that you want, whether it's new or new to you. So when you're looking for a better buying experience, go to Simden Chevy in Mount Horeb.
Hi, this is Lee, inviting you to Ruth's Chris Steakhouse in Middleton. We got a great happy hour every day of the week from 4 o'clock to 7, and our patio during the summer is open too. If you're getting married, special occasion, a birthday, anniversary, or even a business meeting, we've got all the accommodations right here at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. You work hard, and sometimes you're not sure what you want to do, where you want to spend your money. I want to encourage you to come into Ruth's Chris Steakhouse and say hello. It'd be a pleasure to meet you.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
You gotta get down on Friday. It's time to finish the week off right. It's Feel Good Friday on Wilde and Tausch, painted by Hallman Lindsay.
Hey, feeling good, like I should. Walk around the neighborhood, feeling blessed, never stressed. Got the sunshine on my Sunday best.
It is time for Feel Good Friday, painted by Hallman Lindsay Paints. Are you guys getting lunch after this?
Well, I think we've kind of.
He's bailing on me.
Yeah, I'm gonna bail. We're gonna. Jesse and Becca are both gonna come to the VIP.
And Mole
over here at 4, a little bit before the big deal over at Angel Park. So we're going to grab some Buck and Honeys at 4 o'clock.
I don't want to make you jealous, Jason, but there rumors are Becca and Mo are outside right now.
Oh, I am disappointed that I missed out on Mo. I missed out on Tommy. I missed out on Mo. But what I didn't miss out on was learning more about Sunshine Place, and they are our Feel Good Friday. They are the beneficiaries of the Packers tailgate tour stop in Sun Prairie. And look, Jared Goff can think that the media is too negative, but when it comes to the tailgate tour and the charitable causes that the Packers hit on throughout the state every single year with their stops.
Yeah, and they don't have to do this stuff.
They don't.
They are going to sell. The stadium's going to be sold out. They're going to have all that stuff. They don't need to. And so you have to give major props to Mark and to Kathy and to the whole community development team because they're very proactive and, you know, obviously making huge impacts in all of these spots that they hit.
Bob Harlan started it once upon a time. You went on the tour with him. But Mark Murphy and Kathy Dworak and the whole crew at 1265 Lombardi Avenue has taken it to an entirely different level. And one of the many, many causes that benefit from it is Sunshine Place. And you heard Tommy from Buck and Honey's talk about it earlier. He's on the board there. But Sunshine Place supports services for families and individuals who are facing food insecurity, housing instability, and other barriers to family and household stability. One location where families and individuals in Sun Prairie and Eastern Dane County can access community resources and opportunities. Did you know that 1 in 14 adults and 1 in 9 children goes hungry in Wisconsin every day? Sunshine Place strives to enhance the health of their neighbors in need with supplemental food and meals. They also shine hope and help the children facing hardships. If you want to find out more about everything they do, certainly they'll have an opportunity to share what they do at the tour stop for the tailgate tour later today at Angel Park. But you can visit sunshineplace.org. That's sunshineplace.org to learn more about all the great stuff
they do. We thank Tommy for being such a great host as well for Jesse and Tausch at Buck and Honey's, and we look forward to everything else that the Packers and Buck and Honey's and ESPN Madison have planned for later in the day when the Packers stop by. Tausch?
I'm getting a little nervous. So Becca's out there with old boy, and my wonderful young daughter, who has been pushing very, very hard to get
with my support.
She loves dogs, and
they look like they're having the time of their life right now.
I think there's going to be a point where I'm in a cave. I don't know when yet, but I'm getting...
Yeah,
there's a lot of joy dogs
Mark
bring.
The tape!
Yeah, I've said that before. So for as staunchly as I've fought this, I'm getting much closer to getting
You're such a softy, and I love it.
Trust me, that's not the case. But this... I think there's a lot of positives, and I just see her. Look at how happy she is up.
She's doing tricks with them.
Yeah, looks pretty fun.
All right. Well, we look forward to her getting her puppy, you guys spending your time with Mo and Becca, and all the great things that are going on in Sun Prairie today as the Packers tailgate tour makes its stop at Angel Park. Thanks for coming along for the ride with us today. Thanks to Rasheed Walker. Thanks to Rob Domofsky. Thanks to Tommy Anderson, and thanks to you. Have a great day. Enjoy your weekend. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free full show podcasts are available free.